Good evening, everyone. I am Adityan Rajesh, a third year undergraduate from the Department of Metallurgy and Material Science, contesting for the position of General Secretary, Sports Affairs. From a very young age, I had the opportunity to be involved with sports from multiple angles, as a player, as a captain, and as a secretary. From leading the district cricket team and representing the IIT Bombay in the 55th Inter-IIT Sports Meet, my sporting journey was indeed enriching. On the other side, as the Institute Weightlifting Secretary, I have done many things in my tenure, like introducing powerlifting team and sending them to the district level competition and bagging 3 golds, 2 silver and 1 bronze. The girls team was built from scratch and Institute's first girls weightlifting GC was conducted. I personally believe that there are 2 main pillars for any sport. They are community and rigor training. Through my initiatives like Insti Bucket List, Sports for All, Big Bash League for Tennis Ball Cricket and Sports Mescalado, I am trying to enhance the community of IIT Bombay Sports. On the other side, with various programs like SAQ training, plyometric training and reaction time training, improved gym facilities, I am focusing on the training aspect as well. In conclusion, my motive to be the GS is that improve the sporting community of IIT Bombay and make a good set of athletes woven by tribe who is woven to win. By winning, I mean IIT Bombay contingent lifting the General Championship Cup. Thank you.
Thank you, Adityan. Now we'll go on with the opening statement of Anshul Pawar.
From the Department of Civil Engineering, and I'll be contesting for the post of General Secretary, Sports Affairs. I was in the Sports Council since the last 2 years as the Institute Sports Convener and later on the Institute Hockey Secretary. I've been involved in the sports since my NSO days and been an active member in the Institute Hockey team since my sophomore year. If I were to become the GSSA, my primary focus would revolve around my initiatives aimed at enhancing the sporting experience, supporting individuals in their fitness journey, and advocating for and promoting holistic wellness practices. My tagline, Perseverance Till Victory and Beyond, resonates with me as it reminds me to stay connected to my goals. Thank you.
Thank you, Anshul. Now we'll be beginning with the opening statement of Onam.
Good evening, everyone. I am Onam Tamir. Okay. I am Onam Tamir, second semester M.Tech student, contesting for the post of General Secretary, Sports Affairs. A sports enthusiast I am. I joined IIT Bombay last year and immediately after I joined the Institute football team and played second division MDFA tournament for the Institute team. I captained the Northeast team in the startup football tournament last year and later on in December I joined the Institute football team in the Inter-IIT 55th Inter-IIT Sports Meet. I was the captain of Hostel 18 football team for this year's GC. And with all the exposures and experience, I have been given the opportunity to serve IIT Bombay Sports as Sports Secretary of Tansa House. I was born and brought up in Northeast, and it is a land of sports and fitness. Pertaining to this, I was involved in various sports activities as player as well as at managerial level in school, college and also at university level. I was the football secretary of Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi during my master's. With all this zeal, enthusiasm and experience, I, along with the help of my friends and seniors in the sports, have prepared a manifesto wherein Yoga for Health in initiatives, push for installation of mesh work in the Gymkhana football ground, reintroducing Utsav in PG sports, beginners team workshops for the girls sports, and revival of Krita, the sports newsletter, are looked into it. IIT Bombay has a very rich sports culture, and with all the enthusiastic students and state-of-the-art facilities at hand, I, if selected, would ambition to uphold and advance the rich sports culture of the institute, wherein access to everyone in the sports, platforms for the talents, and healthy competitions are its essence.
So now we will be beginning with the manifesto debate. So the questions would be alphabetically and then in the reverse cyclic order. So first of all, Adityan would be asking the question to Anshul.
So my first question is regarding the fourth point in hostel coordination and GC. So you have written boost the fitness level of hostel residents by conducting regular gym workshops at hostel gyms. Can you explain the entire logistics of the program?
So, अलग अलग हॉस्टल्स में मैं डिफरेंट रेगुलर जिम वर्कशॉप्स कराऊंगा. सारे हॉस्टल्स में अलग अलग मंथ में होंगी. हर महीने में कुछ एक हेलो हर हॉस्टल में जिस जिम वर्कशॉप्स होंगे. मैंने सारे हॉस्टल स्पोर्ट्स को जी से उनसे बात की है कि जिम वर्कशॉप्स का क्या सीन है, उनकी सब की नीड है. मैं सारे प्लेयर से बात की है इससे रिलेटेड.
ओके, विच ऑल प्लेयर्स हैव यू टॉक्ड टू रिगार्डिंग दिस?
सारी टीम के प्लेयर से बात की है मैंने और हॉस्टल प्लेयर से भी बात की है.
Okay, what will be the training schedule that you will be following?
Training schedule, हर मंथ में एक या दो सेशंस हुआ करेंगे और हॉस्टल में.
And who will be conducting these sessions?
Gym trainers.
Usually when we keep workshop, the participation is always less. So how much participants are you expecting from each hostel?
ये जो तूने पहले पॉइंट स्टेट किया कि पार्टिसिपेशन लेस होता है, इससे मैं बिल्कुल एग्री नहीं करता. Okay. अगर तूने सेशन से कम भी सुनवा के उसमें काफ़ी पार्टिसिपेशन आता है. हम हमेशा ओवर एज कर जाते हैं उन सब सेशंस में, तो इसलिए पार्टिसिपेशन का तो कभी इशू नहीं है.
ओके, कैन आई गेट अ रफ एस्टिमेट ऑफ पार्टिसिपेशन दैट यू आर एक्सपेक्टिंग इन ईच हॉस्टल?
इन ईच हॉस्टल वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग अ पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ 25 to 30.
ओके, सो माई डियर फ्रेंड अंशुल इज एक्सपेक्टिंग अ पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ 25 to 30 फ्रॉम ईच हॉस्टल. And I have talked to 8 sports scores out of 12 out there, in which none of their hostel facilities have a capacity more than 10. So how are you going to plan to implement a session of 25 students in one gym where maximum capacity is 5 or 6?
Maine hostel sports ko se bhi baat ki hai. Ye session hostel gym mein bhi honge and bahar bhi honge.
In your manifesto, it has been written at hostel gyms.
हाँ, हाँ hostel gyms में होंगे session. मैंने कब मना किया? Hostel gym में session करवाने वाला हूँ.
You are expecting 25 people in each hostel. How are you going to conduct in a gym which maximum capacity is 5?
मैंने कब बोला मैं एक time में 25 लोग अंदर रखूँगा? So मैं कब hostel gym में sessions करवाने वाला हूँ?
You told 2 sessions per month.
हाँ, मैं सेशन करवाने वाला हूँ. एक दिन में 3 आवर का स्लॉट होगा जिसमें 45 मिनट्स के स्लॉट्स होंगे. 4 सेशन होंगे, 6 लोग एक सेशन में. सॉर्टेड.
व्हेन आई एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द लॉजिस्टिक्स, हैव यू मेंशन दिस?
मैंने ये मना भी तो नहीं किया.
व्हाई?
लास्ट रिबिटल वुड बी अलाउड ऑन दिस क्वेश्चन. लास्ट रिबिटल.
सो लाइक यू आर फ्रॉम H9, राइट?
यस.
एंड हु विल बी टेकिंग द सेशन इन हॉस्टल 9?
मैंने बताया ना, जिम ट्रेनर्स.
विच जिम ट्रेनर?
हमारे जो न्यू सैक में जिम है.
The current workload of New Sack gym is more. That's the reason you, me and Onam has included a female trainer in the gym. So how are you expecting a trainer who is catering to around 70 people per hour in New Sack gym come take sessions across the hostels?
Gym की capacity कितनी है New Sack की?
Capacity of gym is at max 50, but we are currently facing a people of 70 participants.
तो 70 अलाउड है क्या अंदर?
नहीं अलाउड है.
बट तेरा पॉइंट ही खत्म हो गया ना.
बट दे आर
अलाउड. नो मोर फर्दर डिस्कशन ऑन दिस. No more further discussion.
No, like there is no clear cut answer.
Enough rebuttals was given. No more further discussion on this point.
No clear cut answer has been given, like who is training?
So both of you are discussing indecisively on some other point.
No, like just make clear that who is going to train.
I have clearly stated that gym trainers will do.
Gym trainers are already occupied with 70 people.
I am finally
stating no more further discussions on this from the any candidate. Keep your questions and answers very clear. Keep your questions and answers very clear and to the mark. Next question is from Anshul to Unam.
हाँ तो ओनम आपने मेंशन किया इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड फैसिलिटीज में फर्स्ट पॉइंट पुश फॉर द इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ हॉकी एंड फुटबॉल डगआउट्स तो ये आप कहाँ पे इंस्टॉल करने वाले हो ये परमानेंट होंगे टेम्परेरी होंगे एंड आपने इससे किस किस से रिलेटेड बात की है इनका डायमेंशन क्या होगा एंड इसकी कॉस्ट क्या होगी ये मेरे को आप पाँचों पॉइंट बता दो एक बार
ओके जो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेयर इट विल बी इंस्टॉल्ड है ना और इट विल बी मेकशिफ्ट और परमानेंट हाँ बाय परमानेंट यू मीन दैट इट विल बी बिल्ट with this one cement and then by mix it means it will be shifted whenever needed so first of all like in it will be in for hockey ground it can first of all I thought it is all about makeshift because in football ground we cannot put permanent thing there so officials come and at that time we have to remove the football this dugouts and all it's not allowed actually so we have to make it makeshift so whenever we need we'll chip it out so installation place exactly for hockey ground specifically there the entrance right now the entrance is opposite place there is some space like 4 meter and the length is adequate length is there but in case of width there is around 4 meter so I have inquired in a vendor and they said that these dugouts are customizable so according to that the within that 4 meters if I take a dugout of width 1.5 meter that's very much adequate in it And the land-wise, it will vary according to the number of seats. Like 6 seats will be there, 8 seats will be there, 10 seats will be there. So currently, I am planning 6 seats. So it will cover around approximation. It will cover around 4 to 5 meters. So that won't be a problem in that.
अभी आपने मेरे सारे आंसर नहीं करे. इसकी कॉस्ट क्या होगी? आपने इससे किसके बात की है? Institute authorities में आपने इसके related किससे बात की है?
Yes. So regarding this, I have approached the State Department, and they have mentioned that. This fund can be taken from the infrastructure IIT Bombay infrastructure fund.
आप मेरे को IOE का chain बता दो कि उसके लिए apply कैसे करते हैं IOE से fund लेने के लिए.
So, pardon me on this. Like, I don't know about that.
मतलब ये तो bare minimum के
लिए आप fund डालते हैं. I have approached the State Department. They are the authority to make this dugouts and all. If approached properly, so I
asked. कैसे approach करोगे आपने?
I asked about them where it will be installed.
आप उनको अप्रोच कैसे करोगे एंड आपने मेरे को इसकी कॉस्टिंग भी नहीं बताया कितनी कॉस्ट आने वाली है इसकी
ओके फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल
मेरा भी पहला क्वेश्चन ही चल रहा है
हाँ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हाउ इट विल बी अप्रोच सो आई हैव ए प्रपोजल आई विल टेक द प्रपोजल एंड देन गो एंड गिव इट टू
नहीं आप किसको लेके जाओगे उसकी अप्रूवल चेन क्या है मेरे को आप बस ये बता दो एंड इसकी कॉस्ट क्या होने वाली है दो चीज बता दो आप
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्टेट डिपार्टमेंट है वहाँ पे हमारा जो रिक्वायरमेंट है हमारा जो डगआउट का रिक्वायरमेंट है जैसे हमारा अगर हॉकी में होगा तो हॉकी से किस उसको सबमिट करेंगे
अब मैं फोन करके उनको कॉल करके थोड़ी ना बोलूंगा कि आप बना दो बना देंगे
ऑफकोर्स तो जो नॉर्मल अप्रूवल प्रोसेस होता है वो सेकीस आएंगे फिर सेकीस के बाद उसको जीएस का साइन देंगे फिर वहां पे सेक ऑफिस में सबमिट करेंगे फिर सेक इंचार्ज वहां पे देखेंगे फिर उसके बाद वहां पे जाएंगे चेयरपर्सन के पास चेयरपर्सन के बाद वहां पे जाएंगे डीन के पास तो डीन वहां से स्टेट डिपार्टमेंट को बोलेंगे
डीन एस्टेट डिपार्टमेंट को बोलेंगे
हाँ जी
डीन एस्टेट डिपार्टमेंट को बोलेंगे
हाँ यस
डीन ऑफिस के बाद वो आईओई सेल जाएगा आईओई सेल वाले फिर एस्टेट को फीसिबिलिटी चेक के लिए भेजेंगे वो फीसिबिलिटी चेक करके बताएंगे फीसिबिलिटी चेक के बाद वो डीन ऑफिस आईओई सेल वापस जाएगा वो लोग बजट अप्रूव करेंगे उसके बाद एस्टेट डिपार्टमेंट से हमें फॉलोअप लेना है काम का okay. इसका ये अप्रूवल चाहिए होता है
ओके
एंड इसका कॉस्ट क्या होगा
कॉस्ट अभी ने पूछा नहीं अभी जो बेंडर ने बताया बेंडर पर अप्रोक्सीमेशन वो दे रहा है कि 70-80,000 पर डगआउट
हाँ एंड आप हॉकी वाले परमानेंट बनाने वाले हो
हाँ जी
हॉकी वाले परमानेंट बनाओगे या टेम्परेरी पोर्टेबल
टेम्परेरी बहुत टेम्परेरी
दोनों टेम्परेरी तो जो टेम्परेरी आप बनाओगे क्या उसका बजट आईओई से आएगा
वो डिसाइड करना पड़ेगा अभी जो स्टेट डिपार्टमेंट से
मैंने आईओई सेल में बात की है एस्टेट डिपार्टमेंट बात की है जो आप टेम्परेरी बनाने वाले हो क्लियरली आईओई सेल के बजट से नहीं आएगा
देखो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यहाँ पे अगर हो सकता है यहाँ पे स्टेट डिपार्टमेंट ने बोला कि वो हो सकता है तो यहाँ पे
काम तो हो सकता है बजट कहाँ से आएगा इसका
बजट उसके हिसाब से देख लेंगे
क्या देख लेंगे आईओएसएल से इसका बजट आने ही नहीं वाला है, मैंने क्लियरली जाके बात की है। अगर आप आईओएसएल में जाके बात करोगे तो आपको पता चल जाएगा इसका बजट आईओएसएल से नहीं आता है।
जैसे मैंने अभी आपको अप्रूवल प्रोसेस दिया, उसी अप्रूवल प्रोसेस में जाके
ही गलत बताया।
नो मोर फर्दर डिस्कशन। Okay, so next question is from Onam to Aditya.
Okay, so Anshul, in your manifesto in initiative expanding sporting horizons, you have mentioned there are one second, I'll just mention it properly.
Onam, your question, first question should be to Aditya. Yes.
Aditya, in your initiative nutrition check, you have mentioned push for inclusion of protein shake, a destination for sports dietary supplements in current eateries. So in this point, my questions are, what is this protein shake? Where do you plan to install it? What are the things that will be available in this shake? What are the difference between the existing shake that's near the new shake and this your currently the initiative? And last follow-up, why don't you ask the existing SAC to incorporate all these things?
So there are at least 500 students actively using new SAC gyms and hostel gyms, and a fair percentage of them are using dietary supplements to improve their gains and speed up their recovery process. So the protein SAC would be selling items like protein shakes, protein bars and protein brownies. I have mentioned the current eateries because I have already talked to a few of them, like the eateries that are currently near NewSAC and HTL area. So they have agreed to go ahead with the plan and they will implement the protein shack in their outlets itself.
Okay, so what are the things that will be available in this shack? Exactly what are the things? Because this is a protein shack, right?
The items which are available will majorly depend on the vendors which are selling, and it will depend from vendor to vendor. Basically, we are planning protein juices, protein shakes, protein brownies and protein bars.
Okay, so these are very feasible items. So why don't you include it in the current existing shack?
Yeah, we are going to include this in the current shacks itself, current eateries. The name of the
current, you are including this in the current eateries, existing
yeah.
one. Existing one, you are including this in the existing eatery.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
Any more rebuttals on this?
Fine, thank you.
Okay, so the next question would be from Adityan to Onam.
Okay, in your initiative's third point, publish equipment details bi-monthly by mandating the inspection of sports facilities. By sports facilities, which are sports facilities are you implying, and who will be mandating the inspection, and how feasible is it to conduct bi-monthly?
Okay, first of all, the reason this is bi-monthly planning of the equipment checking is because, like, especially in the gym part, if there is any equipment is missed, like if equipment is not in good proper condition, then there is a chance that there a fatality may happen and it will be very serious. So because of that, this I am mandating this thing for in a bi-monthly basis. What was the next question?
Who will be mandating the inspection?
Okay, so every sports, okay, I think your previous question was also like in which sports it will be conducted.
Yeah, first which sports facilities, then yes. Who will be mandating the inspections?
Okay, so in this will be included in all the sports, like whatever football, hockey and this your gym and all the whatever is there, it will be included. And who will take control of this is that the SECIS will overlook it, but the conveners will always help them.
So don't you think they are doing it right now?
Yes, they are doing it, but they are not. Actually, we are publishing it online, like in bi-monthly, so that everyone can have access. And like,
where are we publishing it?
We'll create a Google Drive for it, and we'll upload the drive in the bio of the respective sports.
So you'll be just publishing our details in the Google Drive.
Yes. So that everyone, whoever is interested, because not everyone is interested in what is good in good condition, what is bad condition. But if there is someone who wants to look up to it, then they can go to that Google Drive and they can check it.
So, like, what kind of changes will be happening in twice a month in each equipment of our sports?
There won't be changing anything, but whatever there is defect, that will surely be looked into.
So what's the need of doing it bi-monthly? Like if there is no much change in any sport on the number of equipments or facilities, why do we have to do it bi-monthly and update it?
Yeah, so like if you do, it depends on what are the equipments we are serving. So
for weightlifting, it's basically barbells, rods, plates.
Yes.
Yeah, so we won't be changing it or like in like 2 years.
Yes.
So why do we need to update it twice a month?
So bi-monthly is mandating because, as I mentioned before, if there is any improper condition, if it is in any improper condition, it may lead to any fatalities. So because of that, I'm mandating bi-monthly, just for that sake.
So
just for the safety.
Do you think in sports like table tennis and all, in which number of balls are very high, do you think they can keep track of each balls everywhere?
No, see, ball is not fatal, right? So in like, things like
badminton, number of
your question is valid. Your question is very valid. So in this thing, whatever is the ball is, we can see if there is ball, we'll play. Otherwise, we'll not play. That's very feasible thing. That's a very feasible thing. But other than that, the tables we cannot change any time we want. So in that case, we'll bi-monthly report will publish which table is good and which table is in not proper condition. So according to that, we'll propose a certain approval here.
So there's a request, if all of you are comfortable in English, if all of you, then you need to talk in English. If not, then it's up to you. And next is, please try to maintain your language as well. While talking to different candidates, please maintain your language. Okay, so next question would be from Onam to Anshul.
Okay, so Anshul, in your initiative, you have mentioned in the expanding sporting horizon section, you have mentioned setting up of portable mosquito repellent machines close to mosquito hotspots at sports venue. So my questions are, what are the mosquito hotspots you are talking about? There are many mosquitoes in the like whole at Gymkhana. So how do you plan to identify the hotspots? And don't you think this may create a problem towards the resistance of mosquito against the repellent? And have you thought of any other solutions other than using repellent machines?
I hope कि आप न्यूसैक आए होंगे. आपने जिमखाना ग्राउंड में देखा होगा कि मॉनसून सीजन के बाद काफ़ी मॉस्किटो का इशूज़ होता है. तो उसमें आप जब हम ग्राउंड पर खेलते हैं, हाँ, ओनम, आर यू कम्फर्टेबल? तो जब आप आउटडोर जिमखाना ग्राउंड गए होंगे, तो जब हम ग्राउंड्स पे खेलते हैं तो मॉस्किटो का काफ़ी इशूज रहता है. तो मैं पोर्टेबल मॉस्किटो रेपेलेंट मशीन से लाने वाला
हूँ. ओनम इज नॉट एबल टू हियर. व्हाइल अ कैंडिडेट इज स्पीकिंग, प्लीज डोंट शाउट इन बिटवीन. व्हेन कैंडिडेट्स आर टॉकिंग, प्लीज डोंट शाउट इन बिटवीन. यस, कंटिन्यू.
हाँ, तो ओनम, जब आपने आउटडोर जिमखाना ग्राउंड में देखा होगा मानसून सीजन के बाद मॉस्किटो का काफ़ी इशूज रहता है. तो मैं पोर्टेबल मॉस्किटो रेपेलेंट मशीन लाने वाला हूँ, जो न्यूसैक स्टोर से इशू होंगी, जिसको आप कभी भी जाने से पहले इशू करा सकते हो. आपने बात किया कि कहाँ कहाँ ये मॉस्किटो एरियाज है, कहाँ कहाँ पे इनका इशूज़ है. तो जब हम लोग खेल रहे होते हैं तो उस समय कोई इशू नहीं होता है, क्योंकि हम रनिंग में हैं, तो उस समय मॉस्किटो का इशूज़ नहीं है. बट जब हम कूल डाउन करते हैं, बाद में बैठते हैं साथ में सब लोग, जब इकट्ठा होते हैं सब, तो वहाँ पर बहुत ज़्यादा मॉस्किटो इशूज़ होता है. तो वहाँ पर हम लोगों को वहाँ पर उसको सेटअप करेंगे. आप न्यूसैक से उसे इशू कर सकते हो, सैक स्टोर से, फिर उसके बाद हम उसे सेटअप कर सकते हो. पोर्टेबल होगा, चार्जेबल होगा, तो इसका कोई इशू नहीं है.
ओके, सो इन दिस केस, लाइक सिंस आई एम फ्रॉम ए बायोलॉजिकल बैकग्राउंड, सो आई थिंक दैट वी हैव हर्ड अबाउट एंटीबायोटिक रेजिस्टेंस एंड ऑल. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस, व्हाटएवर इन द साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी, सो देर इज दिस इंक्रीजिंग ट्रेंड दैट वी आर रिड्यूसिंग ट्राइंग टू रिड्यूस द यूज ऑफ केमिकल्स in whether it is in mosquito repellents or antibiotics or whatever it is. So if we are using chemicals to repel mosquitoes, because anyway PHO do this mosquito repelling thing in I think once in a week, or I'm not exactly sure, but I think they do once in a week. So they are already doing it. So why do you need more chemicals to be spread out? So because is there any other solutions, have you thought about this?
मेरी PHO से बात हुई थी इस बारे में. तो उन्होंने बोला था वो वंस अ वीक करते हैं, बट बाकी के जो छः दिन है वो एक दिन इफेक्टिव रहता है, एंड वो भी केमिकल ज़्यादा यूज़ करते हैं। जो पोर्टेबल मॉस्किटो रेपेलेंट मशीन्स होंगी ये कम केमिकल एक्सर्ट करेंगी।
केमिकल एक्सर्ट करेगा वो?
हाँ, कम केमिकल करेगा जो पीएचओ वाले करते हैं।
ओके,
उस मशीन से।
ओके, सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वुड बी फ्रॉम अंशुल टू आदित्य।
ओके, सो आदित्य, सो इन असिस्टेंस एंड एनहेंसमेंट यू हैव मेंशन इन द आउटरीच ऑर्गेनाइज GGWP टूर्नामेंट अ वीक लॉन्ग चैंपियनशिप एंड एस्टेब्लिश एन ई स्पोर्ट्स सोसाइटी कैटरिंग अप टू द ऑनलाइन गेमिंग कम्युनिटी ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट। सो ये GGWP टूर्नामेंट में क्या क्या होने वाला है, कब कब होगा ये, इसमें आपने किस किस से बात की है इस टूर्नामेंट के रिलेटेड, एंड ई स्पोर्ट्स सोसाइटी आप कौन सी इंट्रोड्यूस करने वाले हो इंस्टीट्यूट में?
सो ई स्पोर्ट्स सोसाइटीज आर ऑलरेडी इन हिंस्टी बट दे डोंट हैव अ प्रॉपर टूर्नामेंट फ्रॉम काउंसिल साइड। So what I'm trying to conduct is just one tournament for promoting esports and catering to the people involved in esports.
तो ये टूर्नामेंट्स कहाँ पे होंगे, कैसे होंगे, ऑनलाइन होगा, ऑफलाइन होगा, आप रूम से बैठ के दोगे, न्यूसैक में दोगे, क्या रहेगा इसका?
So the tournament would be in online basis. There's a group of people called Gamergy outside. They will outsource the game का IDs from students and they will conduct in their platform itself.
ओके, तो इसमें कुछ प्राइजेस या इंसेंटिव्स रहने वाले हैं क्या?
हाँ, प्राइजेस विल बी देयर, ऑफ कोर्स इट्स अ टूर्नामेंट।
ओके, तो अब मेरा बेसिक क्वेश्चन है, आप इसमें प्राइजेस भी देने वाले हो एंड आप इसमें ई स्पोर्ट्स को भी इंट्रोड्यूस की सोसाइटीज बना रहे हो, तो इसमें आपने किस किस से बात की है, कि इसकी परमिशन का क्या सीन है, क्या आपने अथॉरिटी से बात की है इसके रिलेटेड?
यस।
किस से बात की है?
आई टॉक टू सैक इंचार्ज।
ओके, तो सैक इंचार्ज इज नॉट इंस्टीट्यूट अथॉरिटी, आपको इसके लिए चेयरपर्सन और डीन एसएस से बात करनी चाहिए थी। मैंने चेयरपर्सन से भी बात की है इसके रिलेटेड, डीन एसएस से भी बात की है, दोनों ने क्लियरली बोला है कि ई स्पोर्ट्स को वो इंस्टीट्यूट में प्रमोट नहीं करेंगे।
चेयरपर्सन एज क्लियरली टोल्ड मी दैट यू कैन कम अप विद एनी इनिशिएटिव यू वांट एंड आई विल नॉट कमेंट ऑन एनीथिंग।
ई स्पोर्ट्स डीन एसएस से अप्रूव करेंगे ही नहीं।
You told chairperson.
मैं chairperson and dean ऐसे दोनों से बात हुई है, कोई अप्रूव नहीं करेगा। Final authority dean ऐसे होती है, dean ऐसे साइन नहीं करेंगे, कोई इवेंट नहीं होगा। एंड प्लस आपने बोला कि इसमें प्राइजेस आएंगे, वो बजट कहाँ से आएगा?
फ्रॉम द स्पोर्ट्स काउंसिल बजट।
अप्रूव ही नहीं होगा इवेंट, आएगा कहाँ से बजट?
चेयरपर्सन इज ओके विद इट
एंड डीन ऐसे बिल्कुल साइन नहीं करेंगे। मैंने डीन ऐसे से पर्सनली बात की है।
व्हिच डीन ऐसे आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट?
दोनों डीन ऐसे से बात की मैंने, द एक्स डीन ऐसे आल्सो एंड द प्रेजेंट डीन ऐसे आल्सो।
वेयर इज द प्रूफ?
जाके बात कर सकते हो, मैंने डीन ऐसे से पर्सनली जाके मिला है।
अभी
डीन ऐसे से पहले भी इस बात पर डिस्कशन हो चुका है, अगर केतन को पता होगा, पहले हम इस बात में डिस्कशन कर चुके हैं डीन ऐसे से, इन्होंने साफ साफ कहा था ई स्पोर्ट्स इंस्टीट्यूट में प्रमोट नहीं होगा।
Chairperson has told us.
Just a minute. Both of, are you claiming like you have talked to DNSA sir or not?
I haven't talked to DNSA. I would ask chairperson.
The final authority of the event is DNSA sir. You also agree with that?
Yeah.
So there's the point.
DNSA इसको बिल्कुल भी कभी approve नहीं करेंगे। इसमें मेरी बात हुई है, दोनों DNSA से बात हुई है।
Like how can you be so sure that DNSA will never approve this?
आप जाके बात कर सकते हो उनसे। अगर आपने ground work किया होता उनसे, तो आपको पता होता।
No more further discussion. If you claim a point that DNSA would approve, then there's a point other than we can not discuss on this further.
तो वो तो claim कर रहा है ना, DNSA को approve करेंगे। तू कर रहा है नहीं कर रहा?
He is claiming DNSA will never approve.
Haan.
I am claiming I can push for it and I can make.
Have you talked to DNSA regarding this?
No.
So I am also sure in this because DNSA wouldn't approve esports tournament. And addition to it.
Just a minute.
You mentioned Gamergy also while speaking your statement, which was not allowed. First of all, you mentioned Gamergy, which was not allowed.
Oh, sorry.
In your statement. Apart from it, an official event cannot have sponsorship from any other party. You would also agree with it. So yeah. You told that they would be moderating our event. So that is also a false statement in this.
No, I am saying they will be helping us conduct the tournament. They will give us a space.
Which is not allowed.
You have clearly said that prizes will come in this.
Okay, no more further discussion on this.
So he has claimed that?
No more further discussion. Okay, so next question would be from Adityan to Anshul.
So in the initiatives, third program, launched the inaugural edition of Abhivyakti Embracing Our Heritage to promote indigenous games like Pitto, Gilli Danda in all the hostels and cultivate cultural pride among the students. Okay, so which all culture and heritage are you trying to include in this program?
Sorry, can you please repeat?
Which all cultures and heritage are you trying to implement and include in this program, Abhivyakti?
ये जो इंडियन गेम्स है पिट्ठू गिली डंडा, इनको हम लोग बिल्कुल भी वो नहीं करते, क्या कहते हैं, प्रमोट नहीं करते. तो इनको मेरे को इनका जो कल्चर है वो वापस लाना है. ये लोग हम हमेशा से खेलते आ रहे हैं, इंस्टीट्यूट में आके हमने कभी नहीं खेला, मेरे को वो वापस लाना है कल्चर.
फर्स्ट पॉइंट, हैव यू टॉक्ड टू ऑल द स्पोर्ट्स कोच इन इंस्टीट्यूट?
Yes, I have talked to all the sports coaches and all the hostel GCs.
I have the proof that a particular hostel coach is...
While a candidate is speaking, please don't shout. While a candidate is speaking, please don't shout. Continue, Aditya.
So, a particular hostel sports coach has written confirmation that he has not talked about this.
अगर वो स्पोर्ट्स को तेरे सपोर्ट में, वो तो तू आराम से कन्विंस कर सकता है उसको बताने के लिए. मैंने सारे स्पोर्ट्स को से बात की है. क्लेम करता हूँ
प्रूफ.
मैं क्लेम करता हूँ, मैंने सारे
प्रूफ.
मैं भी क्लेम करवा सकता हूँ.
प्रूफ?
क्या प्रूफ?
प्रूफ
क्या?
अ रिटन परमिशन, रिटन अप्रूवल फ्रॉम ईच स्पोर्ट्स कोच दैट यू हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस एंड दे आर ओके विद कंडक्टिंग दिस इन एवरी हॉस्टल.
मैंने उनसे सबसे ग्राउंड वर्क किया, मैंने उनसे सबसे बात की है.
लाइक So one cannot claim a groundwork like this. Like then I can claim I have done with anyone. Where is the proof?
You know that we don't take the proof of groundworks. You are also aware of
then,
that.
Then how can we ensure the claimings?
The point he is mentioning on event is basically on the hostel scores.
Huh? Like he has mentioned all the hostels. So even if one hostel is not is against that, he can't mention that in his manifesto.
You discuss about that particular thing with him.
Huh?
This doesn't involve my involvement.
Oh, okay. 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 So let's think that you convinced the hostel sports course by to conduct. So. You are conducting Pitto and Gilli Danda. So what about the other culture like Kashmir, Dajibal, Andhra, Cheruguda, Arunachal Pradesh, Parok, Assam, Rostona. So these cultures are not important.
Main initially start karunga Pitto Gilli Danda se and main aur bhi sport dheere dheere introduce karta rahunga usme.
You haven't mentioned that. I asked you. I specifically asked you first question. Which all culture are you planning to implement? You didn't mention anything.
मैंने बोला ना पिट्ठू गिली डंडा ट्रैप गेम्स में इंट्रोड्यूस करूंगा और मैं करने वाला हूं.
यू मेंशन पिट्ठू गिली डंडा.
हां,
व्हाट अबाउट अदर कल्चर्स
लाइक पिट्ठू गिली डंडा?
आई स्पेसिफिकली आस्क फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन.
गेम्स लाइक पिट्ठू गिली डंडा,
दैट्स इन योर मैनिफेस्टो.
गेम्स लाइक पिट्ठू गिली डंडा.
डोंट शाउट व्हेन द मैनिफेस्टो डिबेट इज गोइंग ऑन. यस,
सो इन हिज मैनिफेस्टो ही हैज रिटन लाइक पिट्ठू गिली डंडा. माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वाज Which all cultures are you planning to implement? He told only Pitto Gilli Danda.
I said games like Pitto Gilli Danda.
That is in manifesto.
Not only.
So first question was never answered.
I think we are not going to discuss on the word only, like if he mentioned okay. or not.
So my first question was which all culture are you trying to implement? He never answered that.
मैंने बोला मैं गेम्स लाइक पिट्ठू गिली डंडा जो इंडिजिनियस
स्पेसिफिक स्पेसिफिक.
आई डोंट थिंक वी नीड अ डिस्कशन ऑन दिस बिकॉज़ देयर
व्हाई नॉट
नॉट अ फिजिबिलिटी डिस्कशन ऑन द इवेंट.
व्हाई नॉट इफ यू आर पुटिंग इट इन मैनिफेस्टो यू शुड नो व्हाट ऑल आर यू गोना इंप्लीमेंट. देयर इज अ टाइमलाइन क्लैश.
15 जनवरी
जस्ट वन डे.
हां,
ऑल द कल्चर्स एंड हेरिटेजेस.
मैं ये सारे गेम्स इंट्रोड्यूस करने वाला हूं उस दिन 15 जनवरी को.
माइक
15 जनवरी को होता क्या है तेरे को पता है? 15 जनवरी को क्या होता है तेरे को पता है क्या?
अंशुल मेंटेन योर लैंग्वेज.
माय क्वेश्चन इज वेरी क्लियर. व्हिच ऑल कल्चर्स आर यू प्लानिंग टू इंप्लीमेंट इन दिस प्रोग्राम? स्पेसिफिक्स लिस्ट ऑफ कल्चर्स दैट यू आर प्लानिंग टू इंप्लीमेंट. आर यू जस्ट प्लानिंग टू इंप्लीमेंट पिट्ठू और गिली डंडा और कश्मीर का, आंध्र का, अरुणाचल का? एंड इफ यू आर प्लानिंग टू, व्हाट आर दे?
मैंने क्या बोला? मैं गेम्स लाइक पिट्ठू गिली डंडा इंट्रोड्यूस करने वाला हूँ साथ. बात खत्म. और तेरे वैसे शायद तेरे को पता होगा 5 रिबटल्स ही अलाउड होते हैं, 10-15 नहीं.
व्हाट एवर बी द क्वेश्चन इज ही इज सेइंग पिट्ठू गिल्ली डंडा लाइक पिट्ठू गिल्ली डंडा.
लाइक Okay, so the next question is from Anshul to Onam.
So Onam, आपने लिखा है कि योगा फॉर हेल्थ का आप एक इनिशिएटिव इंट्रोड्यूस करोगे जिसमें आप वीडियो आप वीडियोस ऑन अ फ्यू इजी एंड बेनिफिशियल योगा आसन्स इन कोलैबोरेशन विद योगास्ता. तो इसमें आपका क्या कोलैबोरेशन रहने वाला है योगास्ता के साथ एंड आप किस टाइप की वीडियोस इंट्रोड्यूस करोगे एंड कहाँ पर आप इनको डालोगे एंड इसका क्या क्या फीजिबिलिटी है मेरे को वो बता सकते हो क्या?
ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट वाज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन?
हाँ, ये जो आप इनिशिएटिव ला रहे हो योगा फॉर हेल्थ
क्या है?
तो इसमें आप वीडियो इंट्रोड्यूस करने वाले हो ना इन कोलैबोरेशन विद योगास्ता, तो ये किस टाइप की वीडियोस होने वाले हैं एंड इसमें योगास्ता का क्या रोल होने वाला है एंड इसका ये कितने फीजिबल है एंड ये आप कहाँ पे इंट्रोड्यूस करोगे एंड कब?
ओके, सो in my manifesto I have mentioned a dose of fitness. It's a topic and within that there is one yoga for health section. So in that Anshul has asked me three questions. What type of videos will be there? What is the role of Yogasta is there? Because I have mentioned in collaboration with Yogasta. So what is the role of Yogasta? And third question is where will I introduce this?
And when?
Yeah?
And when? When?
Come where? Introduce. Okay, where? Where? Okay, so what type of video is this? First of all, it is in the monsoon season. Their outdoor activities are very limited. And even in the indoor activities, only some indoor sports are there. And within that, we have to adjust the outdoor sports also. So it's very difficult for everyone to be get in touch with sports. So for that, I thought of introducing some yoga videos and someone asked me, my friend, why don't you share a YouTube link, like they'll look into the YouTube and just see that video. But then I told them that if this video is made by our IIT Bombay students, then they will be able to follow much more.
Agar aapko pata ho, hamara jo yoga room hai, usme regular sessions hote hain yoga ke, chahe wo monsoon ho ya non-monsoon seasons ho.
Yes, yes, yes.
तो फिर वो उन सेशन पे आप आने के लोगों को प्रमोट क्यों नहीं कर रहे एंड YouTube वीडियो पे बेटर तरीके से एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं देन IIT बॉम्बे स्टूडेंट जो भी परफॉर्म कर रहा है. YouTube पे सर्टिफाइड ट्रेनर्स रहते हैं. अगर आपको कोई कोचिंग सीनियर प्लेयर दे रहा है या कोच आके दे रहा है, आप किसको प्रेफर करोगे? सीनियर प्लेयर से सीखोगे कोच से सीखोगे?
ऑफकोर्स कोच प्रेफर करूँगा.
तो बस इसमें मैं वही कह रहा हूँ कि YouTube वीडियो में कोचेस रहेंगे जो लोग प्रॉपर सर्टिफाइड ट्रेनर्स रहेंगे जो सिखाएंगे.
I'll get back to his question. First, let me finish his prior questions first. So what is the, his second question was, what is the role of Yogasta here? So Yogasta is the one like, who's looking after, like they, throughout the year they perform yogas and all these things. So in the monsoon season, I have requested them that around 4 to 5 asanas, yoga asanas, they'll introduce them. And this directly answering your question, where it will be introduced. So in the month of August, around this month of August, we'll introduce these videos in the sports page of the Instagram sports page.
मेरा क्या पॉइंट था, उस समय योगा सेशंस होते हैं, लोगों को वहाँ आप लाने के बजाय प्रमोट करने, एक तो आप उनको वीडियो दे रहे हो, प्लस अगर वो वीडियो IIT बॉम्बे के स्टूडेंट से बनवाओगे या फिर आप यूट्यूब पे किसी सर्टिफाइड ट्रेनर्स की दोगे, कौन सी बेटर होगी?
ओके, सो यहाँ पे दो चीज़ है. He is asking why if you can have a certified teacher, why let it do the IIT Bombay students? So here comes the financial condition also. So we cannot always like buy certified fitness trainer.
YouTube pe free videos available hoti hain.
So please
maintain silence while the candidates are discussing.
Yeah.
And Onam, you don't need to repeat his question.
Okay, fine.
You clearly state your point.
Yeah, so yes. I'm just repeating it for audience.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
I'm repeating, when the candidates are talking, no need to shout.
Okay, so regarding this certified fitness trainer, I don't know what are the concepts of other people, but my concept is that if yoga is yoga students are doing
the candidates yeah? Please don't shout. When the candidates are talking, please don't shout. Please don't shout when the candidates are talking. Yes, Onam.
Okay, so according to my opinion, better than a certified whoever trainer may be. I think if yoga ista students can do it, I think we should go with that.
मेरा बस सिंपल पॉइंट था, आपने अभी खुद बोला था कि कोचेस उसको बेटर बता पाएंगे।
Yes,
तो आप कोचेस के साथ क्यों नहीं जा रहे, आप शूटिंग की वीडियोस के साथ क्यों जा रहे हो?
आई एम ऑलवेज विद द आईडिया दैट कोचेस आर बेटर, आई एम ऑलवेज विद द आईडिया।
हां,
बट नाउ इन दिस
बेटर लोगों से सीखना नहीं चाहिए क्या हमें?
इन दिस पर्टिकुलर
दिस वुड बी योर लास्ट रिबिटल एंड सो दिस वुड बी योर लास्ट रिबिटल आफ्टर दिस इज योर लास्ट रिबिटल
व्हाट व्हाट वाज लास्ट रिबिटल
आफ्टर दिस इज लास्ट रिबिटल
व्हाट वाज द क्वेश्चन
मेरा क्वेश्चन था सिंपल कि अगर कोचेस अच्छे से उस चीज को करवा सकते हैं तो हम स्टूडेंट की वीडियोस बनवा के उनको रिकॉर्ड करके देने के बजाय हम कोचेस की वीडियो देते हैं वो काफी उससे अच्छे से सीख पाएंगे एंड वो प्रोफेशनल भी होगा वो सर्टिफाइड ट्रेनर्स होते हैं फ्री वीडियोस अवेलेबल है उनके
आई कंप्लीटली एग्री विद योर आईडिया
बस मेरे को यही था
बट देयर इज अ बट सो आई कंप्लीटली एग्री विद योर आईडिया बट देयर इज अ बट इन माय रीजन सो इफ योगा इंस्टा स्टूडेंट्स हैव बीन डूइंग दिस योगा थिंग फ्रॉम बिफोर So, in order to promote them also, simultaneously, and at the same time, we'll get the fitness videos. So this was my main motive in this thing.
Last question.
मेरा वही point था कि अगर coaches उसको better बता रहे हैं, तो हम उनसे कराते हैं, ठीक है? आप इससे agree करते हो? आप इससे agree करते हो नहीं करते?
Same question.
ठीक है?
Same question.
एंड क्या ये पॉइंट मतलब मैं जीसैक मैनिफेस्टो लेवल टाइप है एक वीडियो इंट्रोड्यूस करनी है मैं अभी यहाँ से रूम जाऊँगा मैं उसके रास्ते में उसको रिलीज कर दूंगा वीडियोस को इतनी देर में
बस दिस वाज डू हैव एनी आंसर नो मोर फर्दर डिस्कशन ओके सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वुड बी फ्रॉम ओनम टू आदित्य
Oh, this is to Adityan, right? So Adityan, in your sports sensei program, assistance and enhancement part, in your sports sensei program, you have mentioned a mentorship program for sports enthusiasts on a sign-up basis to give them the right guidance and exposure to the sports facilities to ignite and nurture their sports inclination. So regarding this, I have three questions. Who will conduct this mentorship program? Second, when there are orientations for both UGs and PG students, why mentorship program? Third, why don't you let the coach take care of this?
So the mentorship program is basically targeting freshers who face difficulty in connecting with other students and those who find difficulty in bridging
please,
the gap
please
between
don't shout when the candidates are talking. Please maintain silence. Please maintain silence when the candidates are talking.
Aditya, continue.
Please maintain silence.
So reasons for this can be anything like previous incident or experience, issue or incident with any other student, lack of information and lack of guidance. So this mentorship program will bridge them and will help the freshers connect better with the facilities offered by the institute. This mentorship program will be conducted by the sports council itself.
Okay, so like
Please maintain silence. Let the candidate discuss.
Go on, Onam.
This will be conducted by the
council itself.
Council itself.
Yeah.
So, like, since this is a mentorship program. So, I think, as Anshul mentioned before, I also feel that coaches are the best teacher here. So, why don't you let the coaches do this part?
So, coaches are there. One coach per sport. And the freshers are there 1,400. So do you think a particular coach can go to each fresher door to door and address their problems?
Okay, so in this thing you'll go door to door and you
know. No, that's not what I'm saying. The freshers would sign up for this on a sign-up basis. We will be floating a form after the freshie orientation and people who are interested to be mentees can sign up for this. And we will then be allotting mentors.
Okay, so how many mentors will be there?
Initially there will be around 40 to 50, but that will depend upon the number of mentees that are applying for.
Thank you.
So next question would be from Adityan to Onam.
Please silence. Please maintain silence while the candidates are discussing. Please maintain silence. Aditya, you can ask your question. You just ask your question. Please maintain the silence.
So, on my question is on second point of institute teams and intra-IIT. Video analysis of some important games of specific sports or games shall be mandated.
Yes.
So, which all sports are you going to implement this, and how can you mandate a video analysis when many sports doesn't require that? Like you might be coming from a football background, yes. But not every sport requires video analysis, and it's not possible in many sports.
Okay. So, what was the beginning of the question? What exactly was that? Your first question.
Like, how can we mandate this in all sports?
Okay. So, first of all, if you read carefully there, I have mentioned specifically that there is some specific sports I have written there.
Okay, so which are those specific sports?
Okay, so that can be football and hockey.
So just football and hockey?
See, I have spoken with all the, almost all the SOs and like coaches and all. So this video analysis thing is not possible in every sport. Like, okay, it is like if we really try, it will be possible, but in current situation, it is not possible in every sport. So what I am planning to do is, I'll introduce it first in football and hockey and then some other games if there is possible. So from that, slowly it will increase. Like,
so have you done groundwork on which all sports are possible?
Yeah, in my idea, like this badminton, doubles, how we can place, and then hockey and football is a must. It will be there. So why I did this thing is, I'll just tell you the reason in briefly. Because when I came here for last year, I joined the football team. And as soon as I joined, I played MDFA second division in the Mumbai team. So there, from our football, when we went for playing there, the other players who are not in the team list, one of them used to come with us and record the video. And after recording the video, on the another day, we analyzed that video and then we picked many mistakes out of the game. So from those analysis, I think it paved the way for us to win the inter-IIT bronze medal this time.
So these video analysis, how frequent would it be? Where would we be conducting? And which all matches will you be preferring?
Yes, that's a very important question. So this video will not be always conducted. So like in football, we conduct an MDFA tournament. So in MDFA tournament, we take videos of one or two games. So like the same way, other sports which can take videos, they will, when they go out and play with other teams, external teams or intercollegiate teams. So at that time, 2-3 games can be videoed and then they can analyze it there.
Since you specifically mentioned hockey and football, which all important games in hockey will you be considering for this?
Exactly, I have to see into it. But hockey, I think they play with BJTIs and all, right? So like that team, if they go and play with VGTI again, and that match can be captured and like analyzed afterwards.
Okay, so the next question would be from Onam to Anshul.
Okay, this is Anshul's, okay. Fitness. Okay,
let him ask the question. Let him ask the question.
Okay, so Anshul, in your initiatives in the section witness, the first point you have mentioned: elevate fitness standards by pushing for a fitness club manager, not fitness club manager, to oversee gym and initiatives. So my question, sir, what will be the function of this fitness club manager, first? Second, what are the current problems in the gym that you think a manager can better it? Third, in the sports council itself, the fitness club sakis were reduced from 2 to 1
stating that only one is enough. So if only one sake is enough, why is the need of a fitness club manager?
तो जो फिटनेस क्लब मैनेजर की ड्यूटीज रहने वाली है, फर्स्टली वो सारे फिटनेस सेशंस को ओवरव्यू करेगा, जो भी सारे फिटनेस सेशंस होते हैं उनके बारे में। सेकंड, वो पूरी जिम का फंक्शनिंग देखेगा, जिम में जो भी लोगों को प्रॉब्लम्स रहते हैं, जैसा आपने मेंशन किया कि क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम्स रहते हैं, तो अलग अलग इक्विपमेंट्स का लोगों को इशू रहता है, कई बार कैपेसिटी का इशू रहता है, तो सब वो ओवरव्यू करेगा। थर्ड, वो हॉस्टल में जो वर्कशॉप्स होंगे फिटनेस के, उसको मैनेज करेगा। एंड मेरा एक पॉइंट और है, वॉक फिटनेस इसी, तो उसका भी एग्जीक्यूशन में हेल्प करेगा।
Okay, so isn't this work like handleable by Sakis? So if Saki can handle this, because last year itself you council member reduced the this club Sakis from 2 to 1. So if there is reduction, that means there is no such need of
last year. जो फिटनेस सेशंस होते थे वो मंथ में एक ही फिटनेस सेशन चलता था। एज मैंने अपने मैनिफेस्टो में पूरे मेंशन किया है, आई बी इंट्रोड्यूसिंग मोर फिटनेस सेशंस जो कि रेगुलरली चलेंगे, साइमल्टेनियस वीकली फिटनेस सेशंस होंगे, तो उन सबको ओवरसी करने के लिए एक फिटनेस क्लब मैनेजर चाहिए। एंड इस समय भी जिम में मैंने काफ़ी लोगों से बात की, सबका इशू है कि कोई उनको एड्रेस करने के लिए नहीं है।
ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ लाइक दिस इनिशिएटिव इंक्रीज, सो यू आर इंक्रीजिंग दिस, यू आर पुटिंग दिस क्लब मैनेजर।
हाँ, एक मैनेजर तो सारे फिटनेस इनिशिएटिव देखेगा एंड जिम का ओवरव्यू करेगा।
फाइन।
This is the last question of the manifesto debate would be from Anshul to Adityan.
So Adityan, आपने इसमें एक mention किया point, conduct institute first Big Bash League tennis ball cricket tournament open for all students. तो इस ये tournament आप कब कराने वाले हो? इस tournament के क्या क्या logistics होंगे? Tennis ball cricket tournament होने वाला है जैसा आपने mention किया है, इसकी timeline क्या है, इसका location क्या है?
The location would be the Gymkhana ground.
Okay.
The timeline would be right after the start of the semester, spring semester, before the conduction of cricket GCs.
तो इसका आप Gymkhana ground पर कराने वाले, इसका format क्या रहने वाला है इस tournament का?
The format will depend upon the number of people registering for it.
Okay.
So we will be structuring it in a way that we could finish the tournament in days which are before the cricket GCs.
Okay. तो इस type का event आज से पहले क्या कभी नहीं हुआ है?
नहीं हुआ।
तक इसके चार बार हो चुका है फिट एंड रन नाम से, उसने बस उसका नाम चेंज कर दिया है। ये रहा उसका डॉक्यूमेंट, इसमें सारे रूल बुक है इसकी, आप देख सकते हो फेसबुक पेज पे, ये पूरा अपलोडेड 27 मार्च 2019 का आईटी बॉम्बे स्पोर्ट्स का पेज देख सकते हो, फिट एंड रन 4.0।
If you read it carefully, it's let first him, Big Bash League.
Just a minute. Please maintain silence. Let him make his point. Yes.
It's the first Big Bash League.
तो नाम बदल दिया, इवेंट सब कुछ वही है, मैंने सारे लॉजिस्टिक्स
आपको पूछे। So what was the format of hit and run, please?
It was a knockout format.
हाँ, this will be league format.
अभी आपने क्या बोला? Depend upon the red.
Number of matches would depend upon the format will depend upon format.
अगर हम इसको नॉकआउट से लीग में चेंज कर देते हैं तो एक नया नया इनिशिएटिव पॉइंट्स हो गया। ये पॉइंट मैं अभी रूम तक जाते जाते इसका सब कुछ करवा सकता हूँ, इसको पूरा अप्रूव भी हो सकता है।
लाइक आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन प्लीज।
ठीक है, तो मेरा सिंपल पॉइंट है, ये पहले हो चुका है, बस इसका नाम चेंज करने से नया इवेंट हो जाएगा, नॉकआउट टू लीग नया इवेंट, नॉकआउट टू लीग बस नया इवेंट, आपका ये कहना है ना? आपने बस इसमें क्या चेंज किया है, नॉकआउट था पहले, अब लीग करो, और कुछ चेंज नहीं है।
ओके,
और कुछ चेंज है?
इंटर हॉस्टल फिटनेस चैंपियनशिप टू मॉक फिटनेस जीसी।
मैं इस पॉइंट पर डिस्कशन कर रहा हूँ, आप इसी इसी पॉइंट पर आइए।
डिस्कस ओनली द पॉइंट ऑन व्हिच क्वेश्चन इज देयर।
हाँ,
सो या द फॉर्मेट हैज बीन चेंज्ड।
चलो ठीक है, एक बार को मैं मान लिया कि ठीक है इनिशिएटिव है आपका, फिर मेरे को ये बताओ आपने इसके रिलेटेड किस किस से बात की है? इस समय हमारे क्रिकेट पॉइंट कंप्लीट, इस टाइम पे हमारे पास कितनी टेनिस बॉल क्रिकेट पिचेस हैं ग्राउंड पे? एंड
पिचेस आर देयर।
एक बार मेरे को कंप्लीट करने दो, क्या मैं कंप्लीट कर सकता हूँ अपना पॉइंट? इस टाइम पे कितने जिमखाना में टेनिस बॉल पिचेस हैं, टेनिस बॉल पिचेस, एंड इससे के रिलेटेड आपने किस किस से ग्राउंड का किया है कि वहाँ पे फीजिबल है नहीं है?
द क्रिकेट कोच हैज अप्रूव्ड फॉर दिस टूर्नामेंट and he has mentioned, let me come, he has mentioned that the sixth pitch can be used for conducting this tournament.
ठीक है,
the sixth pitch.
Okay, तो जो ग्राउंड में पिचेस आ रही सब होता है वो उसका ओवरऑल हेड कौन रहता है, इसकी फंक्शन कौन देखता है कि ग्राउंड में कहाँ क्या बनेगा, इसका इंचार्ज कौन है?
I am not hearing the question.
ग्राउंड में क्या क्या बनेगा, इसका इंचार्ज कौन है? पोजीशन
ग्राउंड में किधर किधर क्या क्या बना?
हाँ, ग्राउंड इंचार्ज, ग्राउंड इंचार्ज ये सब देखता है मेयर। मैंने ग्राउंड इंचार्ज से क्लियरली बात की है, उन्होंने स्ट्रेट बोला है कि ग्राउंड में कोई भी टेनिस बॉल क्रिकेट टूर्नामेंट नहीं होगा। एंड इस रिलेटेड लेट मी कंप्लीट।
कोच द क्रिकेट कोच एंड स्पोर्ट्स ऑफिसर,
क्रिकेट कोच से ऊपर ग्राउंड इंचार्ज आते हैं। क्या आपने ग्राउंड इंचार्ज से बात की है? आपने ग्राउंड इंचार्ज से बात की है?
नहीं
नहीं की।
क्रिकेट कोच एंड स्पोर्ट्स
बिना बात की आप इवेंट ऑर्गेनाइज करा रहे हो जिसमें परमिशन ही नहीं मिलने वाली, उसे इनिशिएटिव में डाल के क्या फायदा?
क्रिकेट कोच एंड स्पोर्ट्स ऑफिसर ऑफ क्रिकेट,
उनसे ऊपर कौन आता है? चेयरमैन से ऊपर कौन है? डीन है। वैसे ही कोचेस से ऊपर कौन है? ग्राउंड इंचार्ज है कि नहीं है?
So that is not the point here.
यही पॉइंट है, ये फीजेबल ही नहीं है पॉइंट। ये इनिशिएटिव मैनिफेस्टो में आ ही नहीं सकता पॉइंट।
Is there a proof that the specific person that you're mentioning has told that if this can't be happening?
हाँ, बात कर सकते हैं।
Because if
factual correction लिए जा सकता है।
If it's like the other sports clause that you like mentioning, this may be also a lie.
मैंने इस रिलेटेड ग्राउंड इंचार्ज एंड चेयरपर्सन दोनों से बात की है। अगर आप चाहते हैं तो ये पॉइंट फैक्चुअल करेक्शन के लिए जा सकता है। मेरी दोनों से क्लियरली स्टेट हुआ, दोनों ने क्लियरली मना किया। आई अश्योर दैट ये फैक्चुअल करेक्शन के लिए जा सकता है।
सो बिकॉज ही हैज ऑलरेडी मेंशन दैट ही हैज टॉक्ड टू ऑल स्पोर्ट्स कोच एंड आई हैव प्रूव दैट नॉट ऑल स्पोर्ट्स
कोच आर नॉट इंस्टीट्यूट अथॉरिटीज। पहले ये पता कर लो फिर आके हम बोलो
कंप्लीट। सो आई हैव प्रूव दैट देयर आर मेनी स्पोर्ट्स कोच हुज अगेंस्ट दैट। So that means he was lying in the previous point.
If sports goes institute of authorities नहीं है, वो कोई नहीं होते, वो ये चीज approve नहीं कर सकते।
If this point also is like some other kind of lie, like how am I planning?
मैं तो approve proof करने के लिए तैयार हूँ। Chairperson से factual correction ले जा सकते हैं, ground charge से बात कर सकते हैं।
Yes, please do that.
Okay, so like I don't have confirmation right now. I need to ask the particular person about this.
मैं तो चाहता हूँ ग्राउंड इंचार्ज से जाके वेरीफाई। उन्होंने क्लियरली स्टेट मना किया, तूने ग्राउंड इंचार्ज से बात नहीं की है, तूने क्लियरली स्टेट किया, तूने सिर्फ स्पोर्ट्स ऑफिसर कोच से बात की है, ठीक है ना? ग्राउंड इंचार्ज इसके ऊपर आते नहीं आते, तो ग्राउंड इंचार्ज का फाइनल कॉल रहेगा नहीं रहेगा? हाँ,
नहीं रहेगा। ग्राउंड इंचार्ज का फाइनल कॉल ऑफिसर इज द स्पोर्ट्स ऑफिसर एंड द कोच।
अगर चेयरपर्सन ने अप्रूव किया, डीन एसए ने रिजेक्ट कर दिया, तो इवेंट हो सकता है?
If the sports officer, coach, Seki, G-Sec and everyone other is ready to conduct the tournament, he can easily convince us.
No, अगर डीन एसए ने मना कर दिया तो तू कैसे कर सकता है?
Did you ask डीन एसए about this point?
मैंने इसकी अथॉरिटी कौन है?
Let's not discuss about this. Very good point.
Did you ask डीन एसए about this particular point?
जो इसका इंचार्ज है मैंने उससे बात की है।
Did you ask डीन एसए
about this? ग्राउंड इंचार्ज इसमें पिच बनाएंगे ही नहीं, वो ये इवेंट होने ही नहीं देगा। चेयरपर्सन से मैंने बात किया, चेयरपर्सन इज इंस्टीट्यूट अथॉरिटी, ही वोंट अलाउ इट।
वन सिंपल यस और नो क्वेश्चन, हैव यू टॉक्ड डीन एसए?
मैंने जो कंसर्न्ड अथॉरिटीज है उनसे बात की है। आई हैव टॉक्ड टू ऑल द कंसर्न्ड अथॉरिटीज।
प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड,
लाइक आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज अ फर्दर डिस्कशन ऑन दिस।
लाइक ये फैक्चुअल करेक्शन जाना चाहिए ना।
आई डोंट थिंक
आई जस्ट हैड वन यस और नो क्वेश्चन, like can you answer one yes or
maine apna simple answer kar diya hai,
like you are not, both of you are not coming to a conclusive point, let's end this here.
Sorry,
like one yes or no you can't answer,
both of you are not coming to a conclusive point, let's end it here.
To ye factual correction aage ground charge jaisa aditya ne mention kiya, ye nahi ho sakta. Kya unse pucha jayega ground charge chairperson wo approve karenge?
I have never told, I have
usne kaha ki approve ho jayega, usne ke liye nahi bola.
I have never told, I have asked the ground officer and got
a confirmation. Event approve nahi hoga to tu karayega kaise, mere ko to ye bata de.
Like I am
room mein khilayega kya sabko phone pe?
Just a minute, do both of you want a particular factual correction on this? Shall I ask to a particular authority or not?
No, like I am not understanding where is the factual correction coming from.
No, it's not coming. Do you want something to be like reconfirmed from my side or not?
Like I am just asking, has Anshul confirmed the DNA?
If you want something from my side, if not, then let's end this discussion.
Okay, okay. I want something from your side. Please confirm the DNA that Anshul has talked regarding the point Big Bash League with him, and he has got a clear.
I have talked to all the concerned authorities. I have talked to all the concerned authorities.
Please note that he Anshul has talked to DNA and confirmed that Big Bash League won't happen directly from Dean SC.
I will try to confirm as soon as possible from
the sure. Okay. I agree.
Okay. Okay, so let's begin with the procedure of soapbox. So I would request all of you to maintain the decorum of soapbox. I would request all of you to please be silent. So now we would be beginning with the topic debate. There would be three topics. Then first topic would be to Adityan. I would be picking the chat. The question is, what are your thoughts on the Runners Club, Cycling Club, FN Club? The debate topic was given. I will repeat the whole question. Just a minute. Okay, so the whole question is, what are your thoughts on the Runners Club, Cycling Club, FN Club or older communities? Are there any plans on reviving them? Yes or no? Answer with explanation for each club.
So my thought on Runners Club and Cycling Club and FN Club are, like, they were initially there and the current status is not very good. So we should definitely revamp those clubs, because the Runners Club can be used as a scouting method to get students who are interested in long distance running, and they can be converted into 5000 meter and 1500 meter in the Inter-IIT championship. So basically, and similarly, like Cycling Club, like one of your manifesto point, we can conduct 2D INST. The institute is around 7 kilometer wide, so we can conduct regular cycling sessions like night cycling or morning, early morning cyclings, so that we can revamp the Cycling Club.
And about FN Club?
About FN Club, the problem is it was initially started by a few FN enthusiastic secretaries on the previous council. So unless there is someone who is that much interested or enthusiastic about the club in the upcoming council, it would be very difficult to, you know, particularly tell some secretary or a convener to handle that. So I would suggest ki we can either open for a managerial position, but it is again a like extra PR, or ask like-minded people to come together and handle the FN Club page and conduct screenings in OIT or screening room.
Okay. Anshul, your thoughts on this question?
So Running Club, Cycling Club and FN Club. मेरे हिसाब से ये इनका दोबारा से start होने चाहिए. Like Running Club. Running Club में के लिए मैंने अपना जो initiatives है, initiatives में मेरा second point है fitness. वो पूरा फिटनेस स्टैंडर्ड्स को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए है कि मैं और फिटनेस इनिशिएटिव्स करवाऊंगा, उसमें रनिंग होगा, साइकिलिंग होगा, तो ये इन दोनों चीज़ को मैं कैटर करने वाला हूँ ऐसे अपने टेन्योर में. तो इनको मेरे को अलग से रनिंग क्लब एंड साइकिलिंग क्लब का नाम देने की जरूरत नहीं है, बट इन ये इनका जो मोटिव था वो मैं अपने थ्रू आउट द टेन्योर में कवर करने वाला हूँ. सिमिलरली ऑन द F1 जो है एक बहुत ज़्यादा स्पेसिफिक ओरिएंटेड लोगों के लिए है कि वो लोग उसमें इंटरेस्टेड रहते हैं, तो उस कम्युनिटी का भी ध्यान रखते हुए मैं F1 क्लब को नेक्स्ट ईयर फिर से इंट्रोड्यूस करूंगा. अगर जैसे आदित्य ने मेंशन किया, दो पॉइंट, अगर हमारे सेकीस को इस बारे में पता है या नहीं पता है, अगर उनको इसके बारे में पता है तो वो उसके बारे में अच्छे से अपडेट कर सकते हैं, अगर उनको नहीं पता है तो दो तीन सेकीस मिलके इस बारे में अच्छे से डिस्कस करके सीख के वो आराम से अपडेट कर सकते हैं, एंड वी कैन टेक हेल्प फ्रॉम द ऑनलाइन मटेरियल्स ऑल्सो.
Poonam, your thoughts on this point?
Okay, so regarding Runners Club, Cycling Club and F1 Club, regarding Runners Club, as Anshul has also given in his manifesto, I also have given a section in my manifesto of Dose of Fitness. So I have given Dose of Fitness because I think that every student should have a very good health. So if we come to Runners Club, I think it promotes good health among the students, and definitely I will, if I'm elected, I'll definitely revive Runners Club here. That's first section. And second section, Cycling Club. I think this is not only IIT Bombay, this is globally really important. Because in order to become a greener planet, we have to motivate people to use more bicycle than using more these diesel and petrol vehicles. So I think if I'm elected, I'll revive cycling club. F1 club, I think if I am wrong, I think this technical GS can correct me. There is one formula racing body in that part. I'm not exactly sure, but I think for now, F1 club won't be revived, according to me. Because I think that there is a racing body in IIT Bombay itself.
Okay, so, for this debate, what the point Adityan mentioned, if both of you have any of the, like if you want to give any thoughts on the point which Adityan mentioned, then you can discuss with him. Else we can move to the next candidate.
From my side, I'm good if they can ask, like if they want to ask.
First of all, both of you can ask to Adityan only on this point, this topic. Then Adityan and Onam, you can ask to Anshul on this topic particularly, whatever thoughts he has expressed on this point. And then from Onam, Adityan and Anshul, you can ask. So if both of you, Anshul and Onam, have questions from Adityan, what the views he has expressed for this topic, then you can ask or probably you can proceed.
I'm okay with their opinions.
Okay, fine. So Adityan and Onam, you can also question on the opinions of Anshul if you have any.
So Anshul has mentioned that he is going to include running and cycling in the second point, a price of fitness of culture, fitness culture by introducing more fitness GC.
नहीं, ये नहीं बोला मैंने पूरा fitness के अंदर बोला. Initiatives.
A price. Okay, so in which point are you including this?
मैं overall section में include कर रहा हूँ. मैं fitness. मैं fitness standards.
Under fitness, you have added 3 points. In which point is this coming?
Initiatives. मैंने first point में लिखा है.
Initiatives is a heading of the section.
नहीं, elevate fitness standards by pushing a fitness club manager to oversee gym and initiatives.
And what kind of initiatives?
Like different initiatives, like I'll be introducing runner, running sessions, cycling sessions, different competitions for them, different.
Can you be a little specific? Little specific.
Yeah.
Like just, running, sir.
Just a minute. First of all, clarify each and everyone's point, and then just express your views. This is the debate on the topic. Then express your views to the public.
Yeah. So, like, since he has mentioned that he is gonna include this,
both of you discuss on this.
Yeah. So, since you have mentioned that, I just want to know the specific initiatives that you have planned.
Running events, cycling events.
Like,
I'll be first. Like, let me complete
running. Like, let me
get पहले एक बार आप बोलो फिर मैं आराम से बोलता रहूँगा ठीक है ना?
Let me be specific, like specifics of the events.
मैं आपको simple बता रहा हूँ ना. I'll be conducting running events, cycling events, zumba sessions अभी already होते हैं उनके साथ साथ HIIT sessions, self defense workshops.
Do you know what happened to HIIT session?
हाँ.
Like what happened?
क्या हुआ? क्या है? बता दे HIIT sessions.
हाँ. Like we conducted a demo session in IIT Bombay and we didn't continue it.
Kab?
Huh?
Kab karwaya tha apne session? Bata. Mobile channel allowed hai kya iske beech mein? Isliye main print out se leke aaya tha pehle se hi. Ketan, phone chalana allowed hai kya ground ke beech mein? Ko soap box ke beech mein?
So it's here. It is conducted in the month of October.
Ha.
So
dikha.
Show specifically. Haan. That means you were against that.
मैंने कब मना किया नहीं होते हैं.
Bro, nice one.
Thank you.
So like the initiatives that is mentioned, runner event.
There would be last 30 second discussion on this. Yeah.
Okay. You mentioned runners event, cycling event, Zumba fit HIIT already happened. So what runner event and cycling event initiative? Like what event? Like I can say like cricket event, like I could have just wrote Big Bash cricket.
Like तो जो Big Bash का तूने बोला था वो feasible ही नहीं है, वो तो clear proof हो गया है.
Let's just stick to this discussion.
That is over. Like you tell about the initiatives that you are planning. Like specifically what runner event, what cycling event. This is a very simple question.
Normal running events of the state. Simple. Running events throughout the industry. Cycling events throughout the industry.
How can an answer be this way? Running event throughout an industry. Like,
this is what both of you discuss and let you, the audience will judge you on this.
Okay, I am asking which event. He is telling any event, some event.
I am specifically saying running events, cycling events.
Okay, I guess the time is over. Now we can move forward. If both of you have any objections in the view of, like the views which Ono expressed, then you can question a new topic.
I think we can move. Yeah, I'm on.
Okay, fine. Okay, so I will be picking up the next tip and this topic will be start from Anshul. Okay, so the question is, question number 3, do you have any plans for reducing clashes in individual team practices? Given that a few sports share common grounds, also as a GSEC, how do you plan to lessen the casual loitering in the gymkhana ground, indoor courts and outdoor courts?
Okay, so काफी चीजें साल इन फ्रॉम ए मेरा
प्लान. Just a minute. Just to clarify the question for the audience, like presently, the main gymkhana ground, the cricket and athletics share the ground, as well as for the hockey and frisbee shares the ground. So for this, what they are planning, as well as many people in the ground are casually walking. And the like recently 3-4 days before a person got hurt with the season ball, so what they're planning to avoid this kind of stuff.
Ketan sir, could you just repeat the question again? Just
yeah, so the question is, do you have any plans for reducing clashes in individual team practices given that a few sports share common grounds? Then the next part is, also as a GSEC, how do you plan to lessen the casual loitering in the gymkhana ground, indoor courts and outdoor courts? Is it clear on them?
Ketan, soapbox pe during phone chalana allowed hai, messages karna, communicate karna.
Yeah, Aditya, please avoid this. Okay, so Anshul, you can start with your opinion.
Okay, तो जैसे अभी रिसेंटली क्या केसेस हुए हैं कि डिफरेंट प्लेयर जो कॉमन लोग आते हैं ग्राउंड पे, उनको बॉल लगती है, वो लोग मिसकंडक्ट करते हैं ग्राउंड पे, तो उसके लिए सबसे पहले प्लानिंग की रेगुलेटरी बोर्ड्स लगाने का जिमखाना में, जिसका बात अभी ऑलरेडी चल रही है, जो होने वाला है फ्यूचर में. प्लस एक गार्ड अलॉटमेंट का है फील्ड पे, जो कि परमानेंट पूरे दिन में जब तक जिमखाना ओपन है उस टाइम रहेगा, टू ओवरसी की कोई भी मिसकंडक्ट नहीं होता है. प्लस जैसे फ्रिस्बी और हॉकी का बात हुआ था कि वो सेम फील्ड शेयर करते हैं, तो इसके लिए प्ले एंड फील्ड कमेटी एक अलग से बनी है, जो कि ओवरसी करें इंस्टीट्यूट में कहाँ का नए ग्राउंड्स आ सकते हैं, तो उसके लिए प्रपोजल चल रहे हैं. एंड उसके लिए हॉस्टल 7 के बराबर में एक ग्राउंड है, उसका प्रपोजल जा रहा है, तो उसमें इंट्रोड्यूस करने का प्लान है ये डिफरेंट फील्ड. तो मेरा जैसे क्लियरली पॉइंट इंट्रोड्यूस है ग्राउंड स्पेस और फ्रिस्बी, तो मैं फ्रिस्बी वहाँ पे कराऊंगा, हैंडबॉल उस ग्राउंड में करवाऊंगा.
व्हाट आर योर थॉट्स ऑन इंडोर स्पोर्ट्स?
इंडोर स्पोर्ट्स में स्टाफ की अलग से टाइमिंग बुकिंग रहती है एंड स्टूडेंट्स का अलग रहता है, तो वहाँ पे मॉनसून सीजन के लिए आउटडोर टर्फ बनी रहा है, मल्टीपर्पज टर्फ, जो हॉकी एंड फुटबॉल के लिए यूज़ होगा, तो इंडोर मोर टाइम के लेवल होगा, तो क्लैशेस कम होने वाले उसके इन फ्यूचर.
ओके फाइन, ओनम योर ओपिनियन.
ओके, सो इन केस ऑफ दी गेम क्लैशेस, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल हॉकी फुटबॉल एंड क्रिकेट वी प्ले इन द सेम इंडोर कोर्ट राइट इन मॉनसून सीजन. Like, yeah, so for that reason, I think this already existing DSL. So we can divide this into two parts. One is monsoon season and winter season. So in monsoon season, what we can do is already existing is, I think it's perfect. Like, oh, good, that they are perfectly dividing the time upon which this hockey will play and this time football will play, this time cricket will play. So other than that, I don't have any idea, but I'll look into it. But I think for me, that is currently good. And in the winter season, so, as I have mentioned in my infra section, I'll push for a discuss through this ground. So, in the winter, we can always push for separate grounds if there is available.
No, so the question was also regarding the persons are like simply casually walking in the ground. One thing, and presently hockey and frisbee are sharing the ground, as well as athletics and cricket are going on the same ground.
Yes.
So what are you planning for them?
Okay, so this casually walking thing, I also have experience. Like, I have also seen people and I have already commented them. So especially in football, when we were watering the football ground,
people always used to go inside because that Tansa side gate is always open before. So people used to simply go inside in the ground and they just walk over there when there is water. So because of that, I think our coach sir closed that gate towards the Tansa. So that's one thing. I think that's a good thing that we
so restricted entrance from one place. So that's what the question is, like, presently we are ensuring from our side. But still, what you will do as a GSEC, because these things are not avoiding, you also know, like presently also the casual walking of people are there. So what you would do as a GSEC, what present measures are, don't explain that, work on the, like what you are going to act as a GSEC in this.
Okay, so I think in this particular thing, it's all about motivation. People in IIT Bombay, all are very educated here already, right? So if you tell them something, they have to be able to understand. So if you just properly motivate them by counseling them and also, I think that will do. And also, if there is like anything on ground work, for example, the ground is watered and no one should walk. So for that, we can put one wooden placard. So no walking zone. So we can like put like that.
Okay, fine. Aditya, in your opinion.
So regarding the overusage on availability issue in the outdoor grounds, I guess once the current projects which are on plan, which will be completed by May 31st, as per the estate office, I guess most of the stress would be relieved a bit because usually in monsoon season, as the other candidates mentioned, football, cricket and hockey share the same indoor court. So once the turf is being built, the football and hockey can share those and the athletics can practice in the new synthetic track. And since I have already mentioned of including a throwing cage, which will be mostly considered building in the area next to the 100 meter track. So once that is also done, the entire almost entire athletics team would be shifting their practice to the other side. So that would relieve the pressure as the outside ground for cricket players. And since when I talked to some of the officials in estate office, they have mentioned that there is a plan which is on running, which is to build a joggers track and a park and few badminton courts in front of the H15 area. So once that is done, I believe almost the 70% of the people who are using the Gymkhana facilities as a playground would shift to that side. So I guess outdoor facilities would be taken care in the next 10 years. And as far as indoor courts, basic problems will arise in badminton court, table tennis court and squash courts. There will be a specific slot-wise booking system available in the sports app after reserving a few courts for institute team practice. So this will also help the hostel sports course and department sports course to conduct intra-hostel tournaments, which would promote the sports culture among PGs and other hostels more. And also there will be issuance of ID card-based sports equipment, which will be in badminton and table tennis, which would also help the new players to pick up sport.
Okay, fine. So, Onam and Adityan, do you have any question on the opinions of Anshul?
Like, I am fine. I'm also fine.
Okay. So, do Adityan and Anshul, do you have any questions on the opinion of Onam?
I'm fine with it.
No.
And Onam and Anshul, any questions on opinion of Adityan?
I'm fine.
I have a question.
So you can discuss with him.
Okay. तो आदित्य ने आपने mention किया है कि आप hammer discus throwing cage synthetic court के उधर लाओगे।
हाँ।
तो इसमें आपने किसके concerned authority से बात किया है कि वहाँ पे आ सकता है क्या?
Estate office officials।
हाँ। तो वहाँ पे जो trees वगैरह हैं तो उसके लिए आपने PHO में या कुछ बात किया? Horticulture से बात की आपने?
Initially I was planning to remove a few of the trees. Basically the numbers are like B7872, tree numbered B7872. If I am right, and I talked to the horticulture department, and they were like, this won't be possible to remove the trees from the, because of the permission reasons from BMC. And then I found a very good place in between the trees, which would be enough for a throwing cage with a length of 45 meter and 35.8 degrees sector angle.
So, do पेड़ के बीच का distance क्या है? जैसे आपने mentioned like, 45 meter है.
The plot which I found for throwing cage will have the length of this. The paid ke beach length, I didn't calculate that.
So, wo 45 meter hui nahi to? Ye to feasible hi nahi hai.
See,
mera ek
two trees
mera
are
simple.
Like,
mera complete kare do. Aapne mention kiya, do pedo ke beech mein aapko minimum 45 meter chahiye.
वो डिस्टेंस 45 मीटर है ही नहीं, तो 72-73 के बीच में तो आएगा कैसे थ्रोइंग कैच?
टू ट्रीज आर लाइक दिस, देयर इज ऑलवेज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ अ डायगोनल सेक्शन, राइट? यू डोंट हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट राइट इन बिटवीन द टू ट्रीज.
मैं क्या पूछ रहा हूँ, आपने वो डिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट किया हाँ या नहीं?
हाँ.
आपने वो डिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट किया तो पेड़ के बीच में हाँ या नहीं? बस हाँ या नहीं.
इट्स नॉट द
अभी तो मना किया था.
What?
अभी के लिए लिखा था मैंने कोई पेड़ के बीच में डिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट नहीं किया अपने स्टेटमेंट में ही. एक बार ना तो आप कभी आउटडोर जिम खाने में वहाँ गए भी हो देखने?
Okay, now. So, shall we proceed now? Okay, so now please maintain silence. Do we have
any? Let me complete this point.
Yeah.
Can I borrow your pen?
Okay, so just a minute. We'll be having further 30-second discussion on this point.
Like I'll finish it off. Can I borrow your pen? So, let's assume these two are the trees. Okay, the distance that you're talking about is the direct distance from the trees. And the distance can be also be measured in this way, which will always be more than the direct distance.
कैन भी मेजर तो कभी भी हो सकता है ना. मैं ये कह रहा हूँ बस आपने मेजर किया था नहीं किया था. मैं फिजिबिलिटी में मना नहीं कर रहा. बन भी सकता है नहीं भी बन सकता. मैंने कहा आपने मेजर किया था.
आई हैव मेजर्ड इट.
अभी तो मना किया था ना स्टार्टिंग में. मेजर नहीं किया मैंने.
लाइक आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज अ कंक्लूसिव पॉइंट ऑन दिस.
हां
देयर इज देयर एनी कंक्लूसिव पॉइंट ऑन दिस.
लाइक आई हैव मेजर्ड. आई हैव फाउंड अ प्लेस. ही इज टेलिंग देयर इज नो स्पेस.
ओके
लाइक
ठीक है.
आई थिंक वी शुड एंड द डिस्कशन हियर. Okay, so next topic would be first asked with Onam. Okay, so the question is, like as you know, representing IIT Bombay at the Inter-IIT Sports Meet has always been a matter of pride for every contingent member. How do you plan on reinstilling the seriousness and discipline in the inter-IIT camp players that we had before the pandemic? What extra efforts are you going to put in as a GSEC tenure?
Okay, so I think this point matches very much with my manifesto also. So I'll just summarize this into 4 points. So first of all, I'll give them a mission to achieve something in their respective sports. Secondly, you can follow in my this manifesto also. I'll be giving them incentives like player of the month and all. And thirdly, improving their fitness by conducting regular yo-yo tests and all for specific sports. And lastly, video analysis, as I mentioned before. So with these four points, I want to summarize my view on this.
And just follow for this question. Like, how do you plan on reinstilling the seriousness and discipline in the inter-IIT camp players that were before the pandemic? Like right now, many of the players were not regular also in the camp.
Yes, so in order to bring back those only, I'll implement these 4 points.
Okay, fine. Aditin, you can put your opinion forward.
So in my opinion, the seriousness lack in the current players would be majorly because of the 2 years that we lost in between the COVID. And the problem is many players who once played inter-IIT are either final year students who will be busy with their placements and other commitments, or they will be PhD players who are not that connected to the sport after the pandemic. So there was no proper channel who could motivate and who could demonstrate the importance of inter-IIT and other contingent meets to the people. So I think that from next batch, since there is a clear NSO batch is coming in offline mode, we can motivate them directly using secretaries, conveners and coaches, and they would be more dedicated towards the sport. And another reason is, since many of the players in most of the sport were beginners, coaches mainly focused on intermediate level training, to scaring that if they go like to higher level, they might not continue the sport. So once that is properly done, like reaction time training, plyometric and SAQ training, once that is done, I guess people would be more into the sport and it will overall improve the fitness of the players as well.
Okay, so Anshul, your opinion on this point.
Okay. So मेरे अकॉर्डिंग इंटर आई टी के लिए इम्प्रूव करने के लिए जो इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर्स है वो है फर्स्ट फिटनेस, दूसरा गर्ल्स पार्टिसिपेशन में इम्प्रूवमेंट, थर्ड इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. तो फिटनेस के लिए मैंने अपने मैनिफेस्टो में काफ़ी इनिशिएटिव्स ऐड किए हैं जो कि अभी हमने डिस्कस भी किए हैं. सेकेंडली गर्ल्स पार्टिसिपेशन के मेरे एक अलग से पूरा सेक्शन है गर्ल्स स्पोर्ट्स का. थर्ड जो सीरियसनेस की बात है कि प्लेयर्स में सीरियसनेस नहीं होता एंड अवेयरनेस, तो उसके लिए मैं वेव वॉरियर्स एक इवेंट कंडक्ट करवाने वाला हूँ फॉर द इंटर आई टी एक्वेटिक्स के लिए टीम के लिए, जिसमें स्टार्टिंग से ही सीरियसनेस हम बिल्ड करेंगे फ्रॉम द मंथ ऑफ जुलाई एंड अगस्त, क्योंकि सबसे पहले हमारा इंटर आई टी एक्वेटिक्स होता है जो कि हमारा एक बेस बिल्ड करता है इंटर आई टी के लिए. इंटर आई टी एक्वेटिक्स अक्टूबर के मंथ में होता है एंड मेन इंटर आई टी मीट जो होती है वो दिसंबर की होती है, तो उसके लिए मेरे को सीरियसनेस बिल्ड करनी है. उसके लिए मैंने वेव वॉरियर से एक इवेंट इंट्रोड्यूस करा है. एंड चौथा पॉइंट कैंप्स, मैं रेगुलर कैंप्स करवाने वाला हूँ थ्रू आउट द समर्स. मैंने अपना इनिशिएटिव्स में एक पॉइंट भी डाला इंटर आई टी एंड टीम में, रिवाइटलाइज प्रगति, जो कि इंटरमीडिएट कैंप्स होंगे जिसमें अक्रॉस ऑल द स्पोर्ट्स ऑन द लाइन्स ऑफ प्रारंभ. प्रारंभ इज अ बिगनर कैंप, प्रगति इज अ इंटरमीडिएट कैंप. थैंक यू.
ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लाइक आदित्य एंड अंशुल, डू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन ऑन द ओपिनियंस ऑफ ओनम?
नो, इट्स फाइन.
ओके, सो नेक्स्ट इज अंशुल एंड ओनम, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस ऑन द ओपिनियन ऑफ आदित्य?
नो, आई एम फाइन. आई हैव वन क्वेश्चन. आदित्य, आपने अपने अभी मेंशन किया था कि पीएचडी पीपल इतने कनेक्टेड नहीं होते स्पोर्ट्स से, ये आपने क्लियरली मेंशन किया था, तो इसका आपके मेंशन करने के पीछे का मोटिव क्या था?
सी, आई एम नॉट टेलिंग ऑल द पीएचडी पीपल आर नॉट कनेक्टेड. व्हाट आई वाज टेलिंग दैट मेनी ऑफ देम वर नॉट कनेक्टेड व्हेन आई डिड माय ग्राउंड वर्क विद सीनियर प्लेयर्स. दे वर लाइक मेनी प्लेयर्स हैव वंस प्लेड इंटर आई टी इन 2019 आर नॉट कंटिन्यूइंग रेगुलर प्रैक्टिसेस अभी. Like this may be due to many reasons, because many people who played with them in 2019 might have graduated along the years.
मैं सिंपली हॉकी टीम का बताता हूँ. हॉकी टीम में 50% टीम प्लेयर्स जो थे वो पीएचडी थे. तो पीएचडी प्लेयर्स ज़्यादा कनेक्टेड रहते हैं स्पोर्ट्स से, उन लोगों ने पहले से खेला हुआ होता है तो टीम को अच्छे से गाइड करते हैं. तो पीएचडी प्लेयर्स वो सबसे ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट टीम के लिए. मैं अपने टेन्योर में बता सकता हूँ थ्रू आउट द ईयर पीएचडी प्लेयर्स का इन्वॉल्वमेंट काफ़ी था हमारे स्पोर्ट्स में. हॉकी में थ्रू आउट द ईयर पीएचडी प्लेयर्स आते थे रेगुलरली खेलने.
ओके, सो यू मेंशन दैट हॉकी टीम में मेजॉरिटी वाज पीएचडी प्लेयर्स.
यस,
सो हाउ मेनी ऑफ देम वर डिड प्ले इंटर आई टी 2019 में?
नो वन प्लेड.
माय पॉइंट वाज players who played.
आपने सिंपल पॉइंट लिया था PhD people not connected to sport.
Let me complete brother.
कंप्लीट तो तू कब से कर रहा है बट हो नहीं रहा है.
व्हाट आई टोल्ड वाज पीपल हू प्लेड इंटर आई टी प्रीवियसली फ्रॉम पीएचडी पीपल आर नॉट वेल कनेक्टेड टू द स्पोर्ट राइट नाउ.
मैंने पॉइंट जो बोला था पीएचडी पीपल नॉट कनेक्टेड टू स्पोर्ट्स, तूने ये लाइन बोली थी अपने बस तूने बोला था बट बात खत्म. आदित्य ने ये बोला था पीएचडी पीपल नॉट कनेक्टेड टू स्पोर्ट्स, बात खत्म. सिंपल पीएचडी पीपल को कैटर नहीं कर रहा है उनके लिए, उन्हें सीधे स्टेटमेंट दिया पीएचडी पीपल नॉट कनेक्टेड टू स्पोर्ट्स. बस पीएचडी पीपल नॉट कनेक्टेड टू स्पोर्ट्स, ये तेरा स्टेटमेंट है.
लाइक इफ इट्स जस्ट ट्विस्टिंग द फैक्ट्स देन आई कुड इवन से यू आर नेवर हॉकी सेक्रेटरी.
मैं अभी क्या फैक्ट बोल रहा हूं, सिंपल ये लाइन तूने अपने उसमें बोली बस.
So if I write some few
last
words,
last 10-15 seconds would be given on this discussion.
Yeah, if I write a few words that you said I have written that. And you only
please,
said
तूने ये points बोले हैं,
let's not get off the topic.
ये बाकी सब लोग देख सकते हैं.
Is there opinion on the point which we are discussing? Not apart from that, if you have then say, else we'll move forward.
Like I am clear
only on the point related to the point.
I am clear that what I mentioned was people who played inter IIT in 2019 and 2018 from the PhD departments are not that much connected to the sport. And he said something else. And
maybe sum up.
Okay, let the discussion end.
Maybe
let end the discussion.
Ek line se
no, no, let it end, let it be. Okay, so final discussion is like if you have any question to Anshul, Aditya and Onam.
Yeah, I have a question to Anshul. So you have mentioned conduct wave barriers to raise awareness and support for the aquatics indemnity contingent. Like what is in this wave barriers event?
ये एक 50 days to go inter-IT aquatics के पहले होगा. उसमें inter-IT aquatics के लिए थोड़ा अवेयरनेस बढ़ाया जाएगा. इट विल बी ऑन द सिमिलर लाइंस ऑफ 100 डेज टू गो. बट इसमें हम फ्रेशर्स को भी कैटर करेंगे, क्योंकि जब तक एनएसओ स्टार्ट नहीं होता है तो उनको थोड़ा इंटर-आईटी एक्विटिक्स आने वाला होता है अक्टूबर में, तो उसके लिए अवेयरनेस करना है कि उसमें भी वो टीम में मेक थ्रू कर सकते हैं.
टू पॉइंट्स. हाउ स्पेसिफिकली आर यू गोना क्रिएट अवेयरनेस? गिव मी अ प्रॉपर प्लान और शेड्यूल.
ओके,
लाइक आई कैन जस्ट से लाइक रेस अवेयरनेस इधर उधर, लाइक गिव अ प्रॉपर प्लान.
मैं प्रॉपर उसमें इवेंट कंडक्ट कराऊंगा.
कौन सा इवेंट?
मैं बोल रहा हूँ ना, वेव वॉरियर. मैं उसमें प्रॉपर इवेंट कंडक्ट कराऊंगा वेव वॉरियर, जिसमें जो भी लोग आएंगे सबको एक्वेटिक्स का हिस्ट्री बताया जाएगा एंड आगे टाइमलाइन बताया जाएगा कब कब हमारे कैंप्स होने वाले हैं, आगे इंटर-आईटी एक्वेटिक्स कब है. उसके लिए मैं उनको थोड़ा अवेयर करूंगा, क्योंकि फ्रेशर्स को उस टाइम नहीं पता होता कि कब होने वाला है हमारा इवेंट.
ओके, राइट नाउ इन IIT बॉम्बे स्पोर्ट्स का इंस्टाग्राम पेज,
हाँ,
देयर इज अ क्लियर मेंशन व्हेन द 50 डेज टू इंटर-आईटी इज देयर फॉर एक्वेटिक्स.
हाँ, तो मैं उनको नॉर्मल ऑफलाइन बुला के एक इवेंट कंडक्ट करा के ज़्यादा अच्छे से मोटिवेट कर रहा हूँ. वो एक पोस्ट देखकर कोई मोटिवेट नहीं होता, पर्सनली जब हम इंटरेक्ट करते हैं जब भी लोग मोटिवेट होते हैं.
ओके, एंड व्हेन विल यू बी
लास्ट 10-15 सेकंड,
व्हेन विल यू बी कंडक्टिंग दिस इवेंट?
ऑन अराउंड 10th ऑफ जुलाई, अराउंड 50 डेज टू गो टू द इंटर-आईटी एक्वाटिक्स.
10th ऑफ जुलाई?
अराउंड 10th ऑफ जुलाई.
ओके, अराउंड मतलब गिव द अप्रोक्सीमेट प्लस और माइनस डेज.
हाँ, अराउंड
अराउंड मतलब प्लस और
इंटर-आईटी एक्वाटिक्स की डेट फाइनल होने दो, उससे 50 डेज माइनस करो. इंटर-आईटी एक्वाटिक्स अक्टूबर फर्स्ट वीक में होता है, उससे 50 डेज माइनस करके अराउंड 10th ऑफ जुलाई, 10th ऑफ अगस्त आता है.
ओके, 10th ऑफ जुलाई,
10th ऑफ अगस्त.
अभी चेंज कर दिया,
10th ऑफ अगस्त.
लाइक डिड यू हियर 10th जुलाई?
बोथ ऑफ यू डिस्कस ऑन दिस पॉइंट
प्लीज. डिड यू हियर 10th जुलाई?
यस, इट वाज वेरी क्लियर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ही मेंशन 10th जुलाई.
यस,
एंड देन
आई सेड, मैं मानता हूं वो मेरे निकल गया था. मेरा जो मेन था 10th अगस्त को कराने का है ये पॉइंट.
ओके ओके, आई हैव वन मोर क्वेश्चन,
लास्ट रिबिटल ऑन दिस, नो फर्दर डिस्कशन.
ओके, डू यू नो द टाइमलाइन ऑफ दिस ईयर का इवेंट्स कंडक्टेड बाय ISC?
हां,
सो व्हेन द 10th अगस्त विल बी कंडक्टिंग वेव वेरियस टू प्रमोट
अराउंड 10th अगस्त,
हां, टू प्रमोट अवेयरनेस फॉर एक्वाटिक्स इंडराइट कंडीशन बिल. How are you going to promote awareness when the inter-IT pre-camp is already happening on 29th July or around that? After camp, after pre-camp trials, you're going to conduct awareness.
Freshers, July ke 2nd, 3rd to 4th week mein aayenge.
Haan,
and unka start.
No further discussion on this. The time is end for the manifesto topic debate. Okay, so now we would be moving to the next section. That is the background check. So background check would be done turn by turn. So first of all, the background check would be from Aditya. Just please don't shout. Please don't shout, you wouldn't be able to hear what candidates are telling. Please don't shout. Okay, so first question to Aditya and you is regarding your credential. First point itself, like Institute Weightlifting Secretary, so there have been concerns from the team seniors players or team players, like as a SECI, you are not able to fulfill some of the basic requirements of the team, and were dealing because of like no such specific reason given to the team, and this reasons like the requirements which they were stating was like the cleanliness of the room, whitewashing. Then as well as a team player, they were questioning like what was your practice frequency.
Okay, initially the approval was put for whitewashing way before inter-IT camp starts, and I have mentioned the officials that the room should be repainted and whitewashed before the start of inter-IT pre-camp. But there was an issue with the painter. He pushed it and he was willing to come in between the pre-camp. So I asked him not to come now, after inter-IT you can take the room. But during the inter-IT the room was locked to ensure that no one is going to steal anything from the room, like what happened many years back. So they were not able to complete room painting then. But then after coming back, there was an issue again with the contract of the painter and it got delayed.
That's why it has not yet happened. The approval has been passed from November, October.
Yes, that is what the concern of the team. Like, yeah. This is such a small thing for a SECI. Like, it should be accomplished. Yeah. And they were expecting like a particular specific reason would be given for this, not would be like delegated to the vendor, like why he or she is delaying.
Okay, the problem is, as a SECI, I can only urge the painter or the people who are allocating the painter to come. Like, I can't go and bring them. There's a limitation for as a SECI. Like, I have called multiple times, my convener has called multiple times. There's a clear proof of chat with the painter and the vendor, like asking him to come as soon as possible. Like, I can present it to the EC whenever it is needed.
And what about the room cleanliness?
The room has been cleaned regularly. Whenever the key is there in the SAC office, the PHO people will be cleaning the room that day morning.
Like, can you just tell me what is the frequency of PHO workers in the weightlifting room?
Minimum twice in a week. Yeah.
Okay, fine. And your frequency of practice as a team player?
My frequency as a practice is at least 3 or 4 days a week.
Okay, so fine, like I'm just assuming what you're claiming is the final statement. If some of your team captain or denies the statement, then it is considered as a...
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, fine. Okay, so the next question would be to Anshul about your second tenure.
Yes.
Like, there have been so many concerns from the team, as you are a hockey SECI, your first point.
Yes.
So there have been delay in the reimbursement of inter-IT daily allowance, first thing. Then delayed delivery of stick shoes, like which came on the last day. And as well as the availability of medical kit wasn't there.
So firstly, मैं stick पे point out करता हूँ, जैसा आपने किया कि last day आया था. I actually stick last के तीन days पहले आ गए थे. एंड उसका जो इशू था वो वेंडर रजिस्ट्रेशन में इशू था. वेंडर रजिस्ट्रेशन में हमने काफ़ी पहले ऑर्डर दे दिया था एंड उसके बाद वेंडर रजिस्ट्रेशन में टाइम लिया था. हमने सैक में रेगुलर फॉलोअप्स लिए थे उस चीज़ के एंड सैक की साइड से भी एक्चुअली कुछ गलत उसमें रजिस्टर हो गया था अकाउंट नंबर वगैरह, तो उसकी वजह से स्टिक्स का थोड़ा ऑर्डर डिले हुआ था.
बट अगेन, लाइक दिस वुड हैव बीन वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट रीजन, लाइक प्रोबेबली द टीम वुडंट बी एबल टू परफॉर्म गुड देयर.
एक्चुअली मैंने टीम से पहले ही डिस्कस किया था. टीम प्लेयर ने सब ने मेरे को कहा था कि स्टिक्स का टच उनको 1 से 2 दिन में आ जाता है, उसमें कोई इशू नहीं है. आप चाहे टीम प्लेयर से उस बारे में बात कर सकते हैं. एंड उससे टीम प्रैक्टिस में कोई इफेक्ट नहीं हुआ था. टीम प्रैक्टिस में रेगुलर सारे इक्विपमेंट्स अवेलेबल थे, मेडिकल किट भी अवेलेबल थी ड्यूरिंग इंटर आईटी आल्सो एंड प्री इंटर आईटी आल्सो.
लाइक इट वाज क्लियरली क्लेम्ड बाय द टीम प्लेयर्स ओनली लाइक मेडिकल किट अनअवेलेबिलिटी ड्यूरिंग इंजरीज एंड 3 सीरियस इंजरीज वाज आल्सो देयर. सो लाइक
आई एम श्योर द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ मेडिकल किट्स यू कैन आस्क टू द टीम प्लेयर्स फॉर दैट.
Okay, fine. Like, for your statement as well, if the team denies, then there would be a shock on this.
Sure. Okay.
So, my next question to Onam you is, like, considering in the institute, you are only like part of the institute on a POR as current sports secretary of Tansa House.
Yes.
So, I have some particular concerns about it, which I was able to get. Like, first was, first of all, like, your paperwork about the approval which you are taking for the equipments which you are taking,
yes,
was not maintained properly or was not signed by just immediating authorities, like whoever...
Not maintained properly.
Not signed by the authorities.
Not signed by
not the
authorities.
Not the proper approval chain was followed.
Approval chain was not followed.
Yes. And apart from it, like, it has been observed by some of the members, like, you mainly focus on the outdoor sports and whereas in many you mainly focus on the outdoor sports,
okay.
Some of the facilities like carom in Tansa, chess, foosball repair and these things have not been taken care till now.
Okay, so first of all, let me state that I became the sports secretary of Tansa just recently in January. So it has been only 2 months. It has been only 2 months I have become the sports secretary of Tansa. So after that, as soon as I became the sports secretary, till then, Tansa did not have a proper almirah for keeping all the sports equipments. So there were two almirahs.
Just a minute. Question is only two. First of all, Did you follow all the approval chains properly?
Yes, I'll come to that, yeah.
For all the approval chains properly? You
I'll come to
this?
That, I'll come to that.
So you only need to answer these two questions?
Yeah, so this will be related to that, na?
Okay, fine, continue.
So when I sorted out, there were two almirahs and all the sports equipments were kept randomly. There were no segregation between the old one and new ones. So as soon as I became the sports secretary, I segregated those almirahs. One almirah for the old sports goods and another almirah for the new sports goods. So after that, I saw that there were football was not there, bats were not there, and racket grips were not there among all others. So I bought the quotations for this, and personally I went and purchased two footballs, two bats, more than two racket grips, and squash ball. I don't remember exactly, but there was more than two squash balls I have bought. So coming back to your question. Approval process. See, in hostel, you have to go through the sports council and then to the hall manager. So sports council, I have contacted him, Bipul. Sorry, I should not mention name, sorry. So I contacted him and then I went to sports hall manager personally. And I told him that these are the things that are required at the most.
Did that particular person sign on the approval?
No, there was no requirement for signing the approval.
There is always a requirement of senior authority to move forward before an approval is finalized.
Yes, so in this case, since the items were required very urgently.
But that doesn't mean you will overpower someone.
Yeah, so in this case, if you consider these points, then I am guilty. But if you take my points as that the urgency of the requirements.
See, so in that case... Okay, so first point is answered. Now the second point is about the things you have ordered. Like you mentioned very clearly, you bring the bat, two footballs,
yes,
squash balls and badminton racket.
Yes.
So that was only the second point. You only focused on the outdoor sports, whereas the chessboard, carom board and foosball repair was not taken care.
Okay, so first of all, for indoor sports, this squash ball I have bought it. So you cannot directly deny that I am not
involved. Which ball?
Squash ball.
No, I am talking about the indoor facilities present in the Tansa house.
Okay, so it's within Tansa house.
Yes.
So for the sports facilities there, first of all, poker game is there. So if someone like, I saw that there for in case of the indoor games, carom was there and poker game was there. So poker game is there, so carom we can purchase that. So I didn't focus much because nobody asked about it.
That is what the question, why didn't you focus on the indoor sports as well?
Yes. So because I'll of course look into it, but since only within 2 months, someone approached me that they need something. So I immediately, in urgency mode, I bought that.
By overpowering the authority. You ordered football by overpowering the authority.
Yes.
So this is not right, I guess.
Pardon?
This is not right, I guess.
Which is not right?
Ordering football by overpowering the authority.
On?
Ordering football or any other equipment by overpowering any other authority is not, I guess, right.
No, I did not overpower anyone. I have asked sports council.
Did all the signs were there?
No, there was no particular requirement of this sign.
I don't think like there's further discussion on this.
Okay.
Okay, so the background check section ends here and now we'll be beginning with the Q&A session. So I would request Insight to please come here and ask the questions to the candidates. Insight team.
Yeah. So we'll start with Adityan. Firstly, in terms of push for appointing and a visiting nutrition to curate personal diets for athletes, in that point, who are these athletes and how do you choose who gets to avail this facility?
Okay, so nutrition and proper diet is an integral part of any athletes, right? So what I'm planning to implement is, after the selection of inter-IIT pre-camp, I will be conducting a common session which will be open for all, but we will be urging the selected pre-camp players to attend it through secretaries and coaches. So once the session is over, people who are interested to continue a personalized diet plan can avail these facilities from the nutritionist on a like nominal pay basis.
So it's paid for the people, it's paid for
everyone? Yeah, it is paid because personalized nutrition is very expensive and not all the people from the institute are willing to dedicate their time and effort to follow a particular diet. So to maintain the seriousness of the event, I am making it a nominal pay.
So for players from inter-IIT as well, for them also it's a paid?
Yeah, because the main reason is the inter-IIT pre-camp is around 230 people and not everyone would be interested in following a diet and not everyone would have enough time and less commitments so that they will be able to focus on diet. So if they are availing it for free, we won't be able to ensure the seriousness of the event.
Why do you expect them to pay for a personalized diet when camp dinners are already provided and we haven't had any complaints unless you're aware of some?
Camp dinners are not specifically personalized for anything. They are just food items which are higher in nutrition. So diet is specifically for some goals. Like if a person has to cut his weight for achieving a particular position or something in a sport, like they don't know what to do basically. Like there are no enough plans over like net which we can personalize for each person.
Okay, what if a lot of people sign up? How are you going to manage scheduling?
So currently, I'm expecting around 30 to 40 people signing up. But
how?
If,
what, based on what?
Like based on the groundwork that I did. Like
with the inter-IIT sports players?
The current inter-IIT camp players. Like taking I did around.
So why do we have this for 30 to 40 people? You're going to get a nutritionist.
No, I'm expecting around 30 to 40 people signing up for the program if we are conducting it next year. It's a guesstimate.
Yeah, that does not answer my question.
Yeah. So, your question was?
My question was, if you think there's only 30 to 40 people going to sign up, why do you need this?
Because 30 to 40 among 230 is a very large number, huge contribution. And with diet comes more performance in tournaments. If 30 people can improve their competition to performance, it will be very much useful for us, them, as well as the institute.
Based on what again?
Like, just imagine if 30 people are working better.
How many groundworks have you done with inter-IIT camp players?
I have done around 8. I have talked to around 80 people, and around 25 people were already ready to pay for it.
Pay how much?
Around 250 per month.
Have you talked to a nutritionist about it?
Yeah, nutritionist. I talked to one of them, and they were not ready to discuss the remuneration because they were not clear about the number of people who will be signing up for it.
Alright, so as far as we know, budget for nutritionists is about 5 to 8k person. For a normal dietitian, sports specialized one would be more expensive.
No, the nutritionist would be only providing the players the initial diet. One contact and they will be providing the diet and there will be only checkups in the future months so that ensuring that the diet is actually working for them.
This is math is not adding up, I'm sorry. That is for the price we quoted. It's for about 4 sessions in a month. If you say it's for 1 session divided by 4 is still way more than 250 bucks.
So
and also if you think you'll get subsidized rates, I don't think you'll get subsidized rates for 30 people.
So the thing is, the price that you have got from a nutritionist might vary depending on the like number of students we are asking for and the
years. Okay, there's no point discussing this further. Do you have a quote from a nutritionist?
Huh?
Do you have a particular quoted price from a nutritionist?
No.
Alright then, we'll just move on. Next one's going to Anshul. Right, okay. So I just wanted to have a clarification of Weird Warriors. I'm aware that this question has occurred, but I would like some more clarification.
Sure.
So when you say raise awareness and support, what does that entail exactly? What kind of awareness? Physical, emotional, financial?
Awareness about the inter-IT aquatics. Freshers July ke 2nd to 3rd week mein aane wale. To unko initially अपडेट नहीं रहता कि इंटर आई टी क्या होता है. इंटर आई टी एक्वेटिक्स पहले हो जाता है एंड मेन इंटर आई टी मीट बाद में होता है. तो उसके बारे में थोड़ा अवेयरनेस बढ़ाना है एंड सपोर्ट इन द सेंस कि वी आर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग अ इवेंट फॉर द इंटर आई टी एक्वेटिक्स. तो वहाँ पे जो अभी लास्ट ईयर के प्लेयर्स हैं वो आएंगे, फ्रेशर्स आएंगे इंटरेक्ट करने उन फ्रेशर से. तो उनके बारे में उनको अवेयरनेस बढ़ेगा कि क्या क्या हमारे इवेंट्स में होता है. प्लस उसके बाद
व्हेन आर यू प्लानिंग ऑन कंडक्टिंग दिस?
अराउंड 10th ऑगस्ट.
Why?
हाँ, क्योंकि 50 डेज हो, क्योंकि ऐसा होता है कि अगर हम उसको और डिले करेंगे तो जो प्रैक्टिस है जो फ्रेशर्स आ रहे हैं वो प्रैक्टिस में लैग करेंगे. अगर हम 50 डेज पहले कर रहे हैं तो वो प्रैक्टिस रेगुलर आ सकते हैं.
Why are you only doing this for aquatics?
हाँ, इंटर आई टी के लिए होता है 100 डेज टू गो.
50 डेज टू गो इंटर आई टी एक्वाटिक्स का भी होता है?
अभी तक नहीं होता एक्वाटिक्स के लिए.
होता है?
50 डेज टू गो नहीं हुआ है.
होता है?
पर जितना मेरे को पता है कि इस साल नहीं हुआ है.
हर साल होता है?
इस साल नहीं हुआ है.
अच्छा, तो मुझे मतलब मेरे साथ
इस साल नहीं हुआ. मैं ये बस इतना कह रहा हूँ, जितना मेरे को आइडिया है इस साल नहीं हुआ है.
तो तुम जीसेक के लिए जा रहे हो आफ्टर डूइंग ग्राउंड वर्क बेस्ड ऑन वन ईयर?
मैं सिंपल पॉइंट कह रहा हूँ, इस साल ये पॉइंट नहीं हुआ.
ओके, गॉट इट. यू डोंट नो, लेट्स मूव ऑन.
ओके,
ऑलराइट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज टू ओनर.
This is regarding the player of the month that you wanted to introduce.
Okay.
So what are the metrics that you're going to use to specifically judge, and is this something that's going to be different for every single sport? Could you just clarify what the specific metrics for every sport are going to be?
Okay, this player of the month will be introduced for every game. Should I continue?
Nice.
So this will be like for every sport, and like the level of skills, it will depend upon the level of skills. And it will be guided by the coaches.
Could you explain what you mean by level of skill? Is there any objective metric?
Okay, can I take one sport, particular sport for example? Okay, so for example, I play football. And within that football, there are different level of skills. When I say different level of skills, there are beginner level skills, intermediate level skills, and there are advanced level skills.
Okay, just to cut you off here, how do you judge this skill? Is it a coach telling, seeing how I play and telling me that this is beginner and advanced? Or do you have any numbers that you use to go ahead and judge the player of the month?
No, for my manifesto, I have put the coach to be the judge of that.
The follow-up there is that, is it fair for you to have a very subjective metric to judge sports people who put in so much effort in that particular sport? Is it okay to just give it to one particular person and make this subjective?
No, I also don't feel that, but in my opinion, in order to achieve something greater, I think this is required.
Okay, but you agree that it's a subjective metric?
Yes,
no numbers there?
Yes.
The last follow-up here is, what do you intend to achieve out of the player of the month?
Okay, so the intent is very much clearly mentioned in the main topic. It is for the interactive. So I am in the beginning, it's mentioned mission 56. So it comes under that. So this will increase this particular player of the month. It will incentivize the players to be more excited towards the game, to be more attentive, to come and like participate more.
Yeah, just a last follow-up to that.
Yes.
The fact that you perform well in inter-IIT is a big incentive for you to practice. Apart from that, there are other Gymkhana awards that exist,
yes,
which award sports people for good performance.
Yes.
Why then do you want to make it more competitive and make a Player of the Month award?
Okay, so in my manifesto, I have particularly mentioned this. It will be taken in the practice session. So daily practices it happens. So the coaches will observe all the players who are playing very attentively and very, very good in the according to the level of skills. And then at the end of the month, he can decide based on that.
Again, if it's subjective and you're not giving any sort of like say prize to this particular person, then what incentive does the player have to perform better?
Pardon?
If it is subjective, in that there are no numbers.
Subjective in the case?
in that if the coach is the one that is deciding who is the best player at that point of time, right? If it's that and you're not giving any price, what incentive do I have to perform
better? We are giving price.
That is not mentioned in the manifesto. So would you clarify that?
When I mention player of the month, I intuitively feel that it's that player of the month should be accompanied by a price.
What price is that? What budget is that?
So it can be like anything the coaches feel like. For example, in football, we can give a resistance band, so where we can practice and with that. So that kind of incentives we can give.
Is that a good enough incentive for me? Do you think that is a big enough incentive or a big enough difference for people to go out and practice better, considering there are already awards that exist in the Gymkhana, things like citations and colors and everything?
Yes. See, citations and colors and all, you have to achieve a particular level of this one, achievements. After that, you will get. Otherwise, in the practice session, only for practicing, you don't get this Insti-Blue, Insti-Red and this citations and all, on the role of owner and all, right? Just for practice, you know. So it is, in my opinion, that for the practice to be more exuberant, I think this kind of player of the month is needed.
Just to finish, do you really think giving resistance bands to players that perform better is something that a general...
Pardon?
Do you really think giving resistance bands to a player that performs better is something that should be in a general secretary's manifesto? What exactly is your contribution as a general secretary in this particular point, if it is as simple as giving them a resistance band for a good practice?
So this is a very small point here, but it is a minor point of a greater point. The greater point is Mission 56. So within that, this comes under. I have just detailed it there. Thank you.
Okay. So next question again to Aditya. In terms of the mentorship program, we have two to three questions here. Firstly, is who are these mentors and why is there a need for it at all?
The mentors will be people who are interested from the sports background. We will be contacting a proper orientation, selection procedure, and then training for them so that they are equipped to be mentors.
And who is responsible for selecting them and taking throughout their processes?
Selection,
what are the selection processes?
The selection procedure would be through interviews and other modes, which will be done by the council itself. The cabinet members itself.
So what terms of accountability are there in terms of mentorship programs, and is there any particular person there?
First of all, how many mentors do you think will we need? How many people will they be selecting?
So basically, I'm planning to float a sign-up form after the freshie orientation. So people, we will be considering initially around 40 mentors with an estimation of 200 students signing up for this program. So if there are more students, we'll be increasing the mentors or increasing the number of mentees for each mentor.
Okay, so this is like, how is can you please clarify the difference between, it's just for freshies?
Yeah.
So why do you think this is a lot different from ISMP mentors?
Because ISMP...
Yeah, and also, continue.
Because ISMP mentors are mandated for everyone. Like this is purely on sign up basis. Like we are not imposing anything on anyone, and ISMP mentors are there for basic well being and stuff. Sports mentors' main motivation is to promote each one of them who has signed up to pick up a sport and make sure that
if they have signed up for something like a sports mentorship program, why do they need more encouragement to be a part of sports?
Because many people who are in the first year may not have proper idea about the infrastructure and who to contact and how to proceed with the following sport.
So they are just kind of like a guide.
Yeah.
And what's the accountability measure for these? It's not an official, they don't have a manifesto. This is a damp level responsibility, kind of. It's a mentor, right? Yeah. So where's their accountability for being in charge of freshies, who, by the way, have a lot of restrictions on senior contact, by the way, during their first semester?
So the program would be starting to implement only after the initial anti-ragging period.
Again, what's the accountability that they are going to be?
The mentors would be trained with the help of the next SMP OC. And
have you talked to the SMP OCs about this? And what did they say?
They said they are great to help.
All right. And you said the cabinet members will be selecting these 40 mentors, right? So why would the cabinet members who already have a lot of responsibilities be taking on a Dempsey level responsibility in addition to their existing responsibilities?
See, before COVID, it was pretty much easy for participation from freshers because there was a clear, you know, a flow of work and FOMOs will already be out after NSO batches and they will be already playing. But right now there is a clear gap between people who are into sports.
That's not my question.
So I'm telling this program would benefit for more participation from freshman public.
Okay, and?
So for that, I guess the cabinet could
have you talked to any people, like cabinet members, would they have been okay with this?
No, I haven't talked to the
current cabinet workload? Are you aware of the amount of work that goes into interviewing and training mentors?
Yeah. The training mentors wouldn't be done by the cabinet members.
Who is doing that?
There will be an external person coming from outside.
Have you talked to anyone about this?
Yeah, the SMP OC told me that she would help me in getting the proper contacts.
For the external person to train sports people specifically?
Yeah.
The SMP COC?
The mentors would already have the sports background. They just have to be the...
Okay, so basically at the end of all of this, the point remains that you have no idea if these people will be able to be interviewed by the current existing structure because you haven't talked to anyone about it, or they'll be willing to take on this level of responsibility apart from sentimentality that they have for the continuation of sports. Second of all, you don't know any external person who would be willing to train said people as a first degree basis. So in the end, do you think this is like feasible?
Yes, this is feasible.
Okay, cool. That's what you think. Oh, okay, that's done for you. The next question is for Anshul. Sorry. Right, so you have a point in under fitness, I think. Fitness. So it's about the fitness GC that you're planning on conducting. Huh. So my question about this is that GC is generally a very competitive event and fitness is something I would consider pretty subjective. So... So the fact that you are judging people based on fitness, I would assume through a variety of exercises, push-ups, etc.
Yeah, standardized tests.
I personally believe would help in perpetuating negative body image amongst the general population of the student body. How do you plan on countering that?
I think this is not the issue. In general, fitness ki audience rehti hai, wo alag rehti hai.
I can't hear what he's saying. Can you all please stop?
Please maintain silence. Please maintain silence. Let this discussion get over here.
Yeah. Please
continue. So, जो fitness की audience रहती है, वो बिल्कुल different रहती है जो sports की audience है. थोड़ा common रहता है, but mostly जो fitness audience रहती है, वो different रहती है. तो मैं ये उनके लिए करवाने वाला हूँ, GC.
Are you going to have a kind of filter for the people if they say, I'm a sports enthusiast, you won't let them take part?
No, मैंने कहा common रहते हैं, as I mentioned कि common जनता रहती है.
तो what about those common people?
So they can take part in the GC, no?
That is not answering my question.
So your question was ki GC mein hum kis measure pe unko test karne wale hain?
No, that wasn't my question. My question was that whatever measures you use to test them perpetuate negative body image amongst the general population of the college.
I don't think ki koi negative image create ho raha hai. Wo apne will se hi usme participate kar rahe hain.
Haan, I agree.
And it's just testing them to get better and better every day.
Okay, wait, I will explain a bit more. I think there's a miscommunication here. So, when you see people... Yes, anyways, the fact that the people who are taking part in this GC, I'm assuming there'll be a ranking or something at the end, as a result of this GC. So, they will see people above them and they will see that the body image basically means the way you perceive your body. They will see a certain type of people getting, you know, going above in these sort of GCs or having more points in these sort of GCs, and that makes them insecure about their own bodies and leads to unhealthy eating disorders. So how are we countering that?
मतलब in general जैसे आपने बोला कि जिसकी weak body है वो अच्छा perform नहीं कर पाएगा. I think this is not the case. Like you mentioned कि वो overall ranking देखेंगे.
I never said weak.
You said कि जो नीचे आएगा वो inferiority feel करेगा.
Yeah, based on body image.
तो बॉडी इमेज नहीं डिपेंड करिए, किसी की अच्छी भी बॉडी है तो ऐसा कंपलसरी नहीं कि वो फर्स्ट ही आने वाले इवेंट में।
आई नेवर यूज द वर्ड अच्छी बॉडी। व्हाट इज अच्छी बॉडी? दैट्स द पॉइंट, राइट? दैट्स द पॉइंट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन। कूल, लेट्स एंड दिस बेसिकली माय पॉइंट बीइंग दैट दिस इज नॉट समथिंग दैट इज एथिकली फीजिबल। Okay, I will say the whole thing again. I think that this perpetuates negative body image amongst the populace of this college. Thanks.
Okay, last question to Onam now.
Yes.
Throughout your manifesto, you've mentioned three newsletters. First is Utsav, the newsletter for PG Sports.
Yes.
Next is QR Chronicles, a handbook glorifying the participation of women.
Yes.
And there is Krida, the sports newsletter to script rich sports culture. Can you tell me the timeline and the logistics? In logistics, which of these newsletters are you printing, and how do you ensure the budget? Who is writing and compiling these articles, and how to ensure the reach?
Okay, first, what was the first question?
First question is timeline, and then the logistics.
Timeline, right? And second?
Logistics in terms of which are printed, which are online, what is the reach, what is the budget, and who is going to write and compile articles for this.
And third is who will write this article?
Write and compile the articles for these three newsletters.
Okay. So regarding the timeline and logistics, so as soon as a candidate becomes a GSS, General Secretary, so from that day onwards, whatever the events happen up to the next election, up to my last tenure, whatever events happen, all those things will come under that. That's fine.
So all three of these newsletters will go out at the end of your tenure. No newsletters will go out between the tenure.
Yes, yeah, so far that's yeah.
So then you cannot ensure increase in participation due to these newsletters, because they are going out at the end of your tenure, and these do not ensure that people come in because they read these newsletters.
Yes, that's very true, but increase in participation, I mean, this will be, for example, these 10 years, the Krida and this Utsav, this will be released in 2022. So the people coming in 2022, new students, they will look at them, and by that way, I mean the participation.
So in your tenure, there is going to be no change, right? Because at the end of your tenure,
that's true.
Who is writing and compiling these newsletters? Which of these are printed? What is the budget?
Yeah, so every one of them will be printed. Budget wise, I'm sorry, I have to calculate that. I can get back to you that.
How many copies will you print for each of these? And how will you circulate these copies? Where will you put these copies?
Okay, so about copies, I haven't really thought about it, but I think right now, if I can make an estimate, around 10 copies or something we can print and like all provided in every hostel, for every hostel, I mean.
One copy for each hostel?
Yeah.
One copy for a hostel like 15, which has approx 1,000 students?
One copy for each hostel.
So that's one copy of a newsletter to the entire hostel?
Yes.
To every student?
Yes, in okay. The newspaper section we can keep it there, so whoever wants to see that, they can see.
And what if somebody just takes their coffee to their room?
That we have to motivate them not to take.
So there will be guards sitting near the stand moderating who takes the copy, who reads the copy.
Pardon?
Will there be a guard sitting by the stand checking who is reading the copy, who is taking the copy?
Yeah, that's a good point. I think like if someone is going to take them, I think we can put someone who can like routinely
check
it.
Okay, I don't think you've thought about the logistics of circulating this.
Yes.
Who will write and execute these articles?
Yeah, journalism person.
Sorry?
Journalism.
The journalism conveners.
Yes.
And they will be executing three newsletters in the entire tenure.
Yeah, so...
Have you done groundworks with all the current journalism conveners so that there are two journalism conveners, and have they told you that they'll be able to execute three newsletters by the end of the tenure?
Yes, I have done the groundworks, and they said why Krida is up to 4.4. I think the Krida is only up to 4.4, right? 4.4 Krida till now. Yeah, so I think the latest Krida is I think 4.0. So why no other version did not come? Because there was journalism conveners were very less. They specifically mentioned it to me. because journalism conveners were less, they could not make it. And same regarding the Utsav also. Utsav is also PG Sports newsletter. So same thing, there is no journalism part. So if I'm elected, I'll set a specific journalism for that.
So you'll be introducing more journalism conveners for this?
More means that has to be like feasible. Yeah, I'll introduce.
So instead of ensuring that one Krida gets printed, you're adding the burden of two more newsletters.
Yes.
And then saying that we'll execute all three by the end of the tenure, even when the sports council could not execute one newsletter.
Okay, so let me just clear myself on this part. Utsav and Krida and QR Chronicle. QR Chronicle and Krida will be together and Utsav will be different because the PG conveners will look after the Utsav and the councillors, conveners will look after Krida and QR Chronicle.
Okay, just to wrap it up, there are no logistics of how many copies you are printing, how you are circulating them. There is no budgetary calculation.
Yes.
There is no workload management.
Yes.
So there is a big question mark on the execution of all three of these manifesto points.
Okay.
Do you have any response to everything that I just said?
No, I am fine with it. Thank you.
So there is a factual correction for Adityan. He stated that ISMP OC would be helping and like mentoring the students or in the process. So we just confirmed from the respective ISMP OCs and they clearly told that this idea is not feasible.
Excuse me, which are we supposed to?
So the factual correction is the SMP will not be providing any help in giving you any kind of training, not even the contact sharing of the trainer. That is
but,
what you
but it was,
in the answer.
It was like mentioned that they would be providing the contacts of whom to contact to train the mentors.
Right. I just confirmed with the person whom you did groundwork with. The person said no.
Sorry, it's been a mistake from my side.
Okay, so we can end with the Q&A session from the inside. And now all the candidates complete, no one should leave. So first of all, we're beginning in the reverse order. Onam would be stating his closing statement first.
Hello. So by now, all of you must have a gist of our manifestos. So first of all, thank you everyone. So this is my manifesto here, which I prepared with thorough groundworks and consultations. And all the points in this manifesto has been included for the betterment of the IITB sports community. So to this, if given the chance, I would uphold and advance the sports culture of IITB through inter-IIT betterment, pushing for better facilities, and above all, inclusivity of all the students into the sports culture. Thank you.
Okay, so the next closing statement would be of Anshul Pawar.
I would like to thank everyone who came here for the soapbox. This is my manifesto which I have made through sheer efforts and groundworks. In addition to the previously discussed points in my manifesto, I am committed to put dedicated efforts towards introducing programs and schemes that encourage physical fitness, well-being, and overall enhancement of their sports. So thank you everyone for coming here.
The next closing statement will be of Adityan.
I, Adityan Rajesh, using the aforementioned initiatives and programs, would ensure that I would work my best
for each person in the institute provide equal and opportunity chance in sports. Thank you.
Thank you everyone whoever present here in the soapbox for General Secretary Sports Affairs NCR.